Ravens rule the roost today? Let's go upstairs to find out from Don Taylor and Brian Shanahan.
Thank you very much, C-Mac. Before we do anything else, we want to welcome our viewers from Sportsnet Ontario. Don Taylor here along with Brian Shanahan. Brian, Craig mentioned that The Rock defeated the Ravens 16-11 the first time they met a couple of weeks ago. Since then, the Ravens have bolstered their lineup in an offensive way.
Yeah, and I think they're going to be ready. They learned from their mistakes. Paul DeMonte's a good coach, and you see, here's a guy we didn't see 2 weeks ago in Toronto, big 6'6", Peter Morgan, and he was playing basketball for Simon Fraser, but I'm told he's not playing for them anymore.
He has quit the SFU basketball program. Keep in mind, he was playing basketball, he's a double economics major, and he's playing lacrosse. Something had to give. He decided that, he'd take the paying job. He's going to stick around and play with the Ravens right now. As for The Rock, they've got the steady veteran in goal, Mr. Bob Watson.
Yeah, they're a veteran team, starting with the veteran goalie, Bob Watson, 31 years old from Guelph, Ontario. This is his sixth year in this league, and they have a tough defense, but he solidifies the defense starting from him. Great saves.
Once again, 16-11, the last time these two teams met 2 weeks ago. It's The Rock and the Ravens as the National Lacrosse League comes to the city of Vancouver and GM Place. Molson Export National Lacrosse is brought to you by Molson Export. Add X today.
The best thing about the Coors Light Silver Sweet football party is you don't have to play football to get in. See details at a participating bar near you. No purchase necessary. Must be legal drinking age. Are you ready for some football?
You seen the guy in the mailroom?
Oh, talk about buns o' steel. Oh.
Come to mama, big boy.
Tostitos, chips, and salsa. Dig in.
Let loose.
Sony Mini Disc Walkman, you can record from the net. So wherever you go, your downloads go with you.
Two highly skilled teams square off when Daniel Alfredson and the Ottawa Senators take on Joe Sakic and the Colorado Avalanche. NHL Game Night, Monday.
Just moments away now from the first NLL game ever at GM Place, the Vancouver Ravens and Toronto Rock, and I'm joined now by Rock head coach Les Bartley. And what are you going to have to do today to make sure that you take this crowd out of the game? Because obviously there's going to be some big emotion coming from the Vancouver players.
Yeah, I mean, obviously you like to get an early lead, score the first goal and try and build on that. But that a lot of times doesn't happen in buildings like this when they're playing their first game here ever. You know, Vancouver's a great lacrosse town. They've got a lot of great players, and we have to be at our best today.
Thank you very much. Best of luck to you. And we will be on our best, no doubt. Upstairs now to two of the best, Don Taylor and Brian Shanahan. Gentlemen.
All right. Thank you very much, C-Mac. Our starting goaltenders tonight, by the way, today's starting goalies are brought to you by Wendy's. Two new bacon Swiss combos. Try one today and one tomorrow. Bob Watson, as we mentioned, starting in goal for the Toronto Rock. Vancouver lacrosse fans, of course, Brian, remember him from the Man Cup.
Yeah, he came out. He still hasn't won a Man Cup. It was an exciting series, seven games out here, but he's a great goaltender.
Playing for the Brampton Excelsiors, of course. At the other end for the Ravens, 40-year-old Dwight Maetche. 40 years old, how does he keep in shape, you ask? He does yoga.
That's what I hear, but he played great in Toronto.
Now it's time for the Dodge matchup of the game. Let's take a look at our Dodge matchup of the game, brought to you by Dodge. Folks, grab lights, by the Hornets. Man, these two guys had an interesting confrontation during the first time these teams met. Right,
exactly. If you saw that game, you would think they were enemies in the last few years in Toronto. But Dan Lattiser really did a number on Chris Gill. He still got his 4 goals, 1 assist, but he took some punishment for it.
Yeah, boy, you got to wonder what was going on there. I mean, Dan Lattiser and Chris Gill, of course, older teammates with the Toronto Rockets.
Dan's kind of a quiet guy, and then Chris Gill likes to give guys the gears. I guess there's a little bit of payback.
I don't think his elbows are quiet.
No.
Although at that moment, I don't think Chris Gill was hearing much. Boy, that was just a wicked hit. Paul DeMonte, of course, head coach and director of lacrosse operations for the Vancouver Ravens. People around the Vancouver area know him best as the head coach of the Burnaby Lakers, very successful junior A lacrosse club.
Yeah, very well-known lacrosse man, and he's done some homework over the last 2 weeks. I heard him the other day, he was saying it was a good thing having a couple weeks off. It allowed them a few bodies to heal, but also I think it gave him more time to plan for this game.
Your first quarter, folks, is brought to you by hotjobs.ca. Log on today and take control of your destiny. Hotjobs.ca. Crowd just starting to file in here at GM Place. Keep in mind that the two end zones of the upper tier are not being sold by the Ravens. So attendance here at the garage is around 16,900. Brian, Vancouver, traditionally, the fans here get to the games a little bit later. So we expect the seats to fill up a lot more as the game goes on.
Yeah, well, they're expecting over 13,000, which would be fantastic. Everybody talks about the success of the Rock in Toronto. They only had about 11, 12,000 their first game. So this is great.
All right, we're just waiting the opening faceoff. I guess a few kinks to be worked out. We understand there's a problem with the shot clock here at GM Place.
We saw the referees were at both benches there. They're probably trying to determine a backup method. Sometimes they'll call something out, but they've got to make sure it's agreeable to both of the coaches.
Hey, let's take a look right now at our Yamaha Motors Keys to the Game, brought to you by Yamaha Motors, when you want the best.
Hey, I'm Pat Coyle from the Toronto Rock, and our keys for the game tonight are to shut down their offensive players like Chris Gill and Peter Morgan, for us to transition the ball and to play physical defense.
Hi, my name is Bruce Murray from the Vancouver Ravens, and the keys to our game are going to be getting the loose balls and having our offense fill the net.
Yeah. That might be easier said
than
done.
Score more goals than the other team. That's one of the keys to lacrosse. Good job at Bruce Murray. I mean, you know what? And Bruce Murray looked a little bit nervous there. You can't blame him. I walked into the Vancouver dressing room. You could cut the tension with a knife. I know they've played 2 games already away from home, Brian, but I think that it's a different thing on the road. Here is our opening faceoff, and taking the faceoff for the Ravens. First ever faceoff at home. Craig Stevenson going up against Steve Toll. The National Lacrosse League is alive in Vancouver.
This is one area where Toronto dominated in the faceoffs last game, but here you see Vancouver win the first one.
Darren Reisig, Ravens captain, with the ball right now as they set up the offense. Todd Gill loses control. Looks like Bob Watson will take it in the crease. Headbands the puck, or part of the ball. Already made the mistake.
That's right.
Game's a minute old, and I already said
I'll
puck.
I'll forgive you for one, but next time I'm hitting you.
If I say ice, I'm fired. This is Daryl Gibson with the ball. Pardon me, that was Kim Squire with the ball for the Rock. Squire gets back, setting up the offense. Right side to Colin Doyle, the Coquitlam Adneck. Raymond's shot off the post. Shot by Kenny Millen.
He had beat Maetche on that one, and Maetche got a bit of luck there.
This is Stewartson. Over to Stevenson for the Ravens. We're early in the game, no score. Rock already with one goalpost. Here comes big Peter Morgan, the guy they're depending on to spark their offense. Gets it to Jamie Bowen. Jamie Bowen's got some room. Shot saved by Watson. Now here come the Rock. Team change lines. This is Steve Toll on the right side. Steve Toll stops, looks to set things up. Steve Toll dumps it off. And here's Jimmy Veltman for the Rock now. The veteran Jimmy Veltman. Long time lacrosse superstar. Rock on the attack.
Roddy Squire, Roddy Squire, belted around. Good job on defense by Rich Cadden. And they want to go. Squire and Cadden. Right now, nothing more than a wrestling match. Although we could have some preliminary bouts happening there.
And Rod Squire's not a big man, but he's tough as nails.
Well, I tell you, Rich Cadden did an excellent job defensively there, and obviously old Squire took offense to it.
Let's see how this started. That's Roddy Squire with the ball. Rich Cadden, a good defender, doing a job on him.
Nothing wrong with that.
Nothing wrong. Roddy's just asserting himself.
Jamie Bowen losing control for the Ravens. Still fights for it. Here comes Stevenson for the home team. Working off the screen. Stevenson trying to get some room. Moves in front. Weak shot. Watson handles it. No problem. Here comes the Toronto offense. Watson getting the ball up ahead for Glenn Clark as the Ravens are caught in a line change. Hit there by Grant Hamilton, but Clark maintains control. Glenn Clark, no, he's not the former premier. To Squire, shot saved by Dwight Maetche. In the goaltender-only uniform for the Ravens. Now Kyle Goundrey for Vancouver. 0-0 early in the first quarter here at GM Place. The first National Lacrosse League game in Vancouver. Peter Morgan off the pick in front, shot. Wang Watson got a piece of that on the shot by Darren Rising. Ball midcourt. Ryan Connor racing to it with Millen, gets it back to Dwight Maetche. Yes, you can go back in the crease in the National Lacrosse League for you old-time lacrosse fans.
Yes, and the defense uses that play a lot. It really helps take the pressure off. So far, I'm impressed with Vancouver. They look a little intimidated in Toronto, not by the size, but just by the type of game, the crowd. So far, they've been very tough.
Boy, Bob Watson is good with that stick. He gathers that one into the crease and starts the Toronto offense. This is Carter Livingstone, the Livingstonian one. Veltman looking for someone to pass to. And he finds Colin Doyle. Colin Doyle in front, shot saved by Dwight Maetche. Is that in the crease, I think, Brian?
That was in the crease, yes, just a little bit.
Maetche starts the offense. Hansen for the Ravens as he wants to set things up. Looked like he had a little bit of room there. He decided to stop, set things up.
Both teams are getting their defensive players on very fast.
Here's Peter Morgan. Big Peter Morgan in front, saved by Bob Watson. Bob Watson looks sharp early. Yeah,
Peter Morgan looks like he'll be a tough guy to cover. 6 foot six. Reminds me of Ben Helge. He's a great lacrosse player from New Westminster.
Yeah.
Same build.
Ben, like Peter, also a pretty good basketball player. His brother Bob played for several years at SFU. Ball goes down to the Toronto end, or Mr. Watson will pick it up. 0-0, about 4.5 minutes into quarter number one. And just in case you're wondering, I've already called the ball a puck. Let's get out of Craig McEwen.
Thanks, you, Donnie. Something we may want to keep an eye on, number eight for the Vancouver Ravens, Craig Stevenson. He took the opening faceoff, but he left the warm-up. He rolled his ankle a little bit, had to be helped off, but they said it was just a stinger. I'm not sure you can get a stinger in your ankle, but that's the case. We'll have to keep an eye on that this afternoon.
Yeah, well, don't tell that to Mr. Stevenson. I'm sure it stings. Watson with another save. The shot there by Ryan O'Connor. Ryan O'Connor takes a bump, keeps the ball. Jamie Bowen on the right side now. Reisig back to O'Connor. He's got that nice shot from the point. Shot it wide that time, though. Here come the Rock. Glenn Clark moving in. Nice little bounce pass. Shot and a goal.
Oh, that was a beauty.
Pretty. Stephen Toll rippling the mesh behind Dwight Maetche.
As Stephen Toll, speedy they call him, has been a great weapon for Toronto. He is maybe the fastest guy in the league, but this is the transition game here. They came out of their end really fast. One guy goes to the bench, a guy comes out. Watch Toll coming straight down the middle. And watch this bounce pass.
Isn't that nice?
That was beautiful. Nice pass by Glenn Clark. The stick's in the way. He has to bounce it down. Nice fake.
You know, you say nice pass, too. Also, good job by Toll of picking up the pass. It's not easy to pick up a bounce pass from close
and
in.
And even on this carpet, it bounces a little differently than it does on the floor in the summer. The guys take some getting used to.
I tell you, I love this carpet. I mean, as somebody who's watched a lot of lacrosse on the old concrete floors, you can see the ball a lot easier. Shot there by Stevenson. No problem for Bob Watson. I said it before, I'll say it again. Bob Watson is looking extremely sharp in the Toronto cage. This is Millen for the Rock. Millen, Rock with a 1-0 lead. Shot saved by Maetche. Mike Murray with the shot there, and here come the Ravens. This is Stewartson. Stewartson, one man to beat. He's going to try to beat him. Nope. Thinks better of it. Peels back, and he'll try to set up the offense for the Vancouver Ravens. It's a 1-0 game in favor of the Rock. We're 6 minutes into quarter one here at GM Place. Peter Morgan, beautifully checked there by Daryl Gibson.
Great defense
enough of
by
the stick.
Gibson there.
Shot clock running down. 2 seconds left, and it doesn't matter. Bob Watson picks it up. Here come the Rock. Clark, who did such a beautiful job on that 2-on-1 to set up the goal by Toole. Now Kim Squire plays with the Coquitlam Adnacks in the summer. Helped them win a man cup. On the right side to Dance Fruit. Shot and a goal. Should be the left side to Dan Stroop. Bottom line, the ball went into the net.
Well, I tell you, Danny Stroop, sometimes you might think he's invisible for a while, but when he gets that shot and when he's on, and so far this season he's been on, he makes a play out of nothing. He's up high. Beautiful bounce shot. We talk about the different bounce on the carpet. I don't think Maetche was ready for this one.
Yeah, Dan Stroop scoring against Vancouver, nothing new. He had 5 goals and 1 assist 2 weeks ago at the ACC.
And even Dan said that game, a bit of its luck. He had a quiet night, other than every time he shot, it went in.
Well, Dan is Mr. Humble. I watched that game. He looked pretty darn good to me.
He has the ability to play a game without looking dominating, yeah, but still have a great finish.
This is Stevenson for the Ravens, the big Peter Morgan to Ryan O'Connor. Ryan O'Connor scored the first ever Ravens goal. His shot, likes to use it. Watson again, equal to the task for the Toronto Rock.
And Ryan O'Connor has a good outside shot too.
Long pass for Millen. Doesn't connect. Dwight Maetche has the ball for the Vancouver Ravens. It's 2-0 here at GM Place. 8 minutes left in quarter number one. Big Bruce Murray dumps the ball off. Luke Ansley, the youngster, newest Mr. Junior for the Ravens. Luke Ansley looking to move in. Nice little pass. No go. Bob Watson has it again.
Toronto's getting a penalty for holding here. Maetche race to the bench.
2-0 for the Toronto Rock over the Vancouver Ravens. You're watching the NLL.
Can anybody find me somebody to love? Every day of my life, I work till I ache my bones. At the end of the day, I take home my hard-earned pay on my own. Somebody. Can anybody find me somebody to love?
Okay.
Welcome back, everybody.
Okay, that's fine.
I'm joined now by Dan Stroop. And what is it about scoring goals against Vancouver?
Oh, I don't know. I got lucky there. I got the screenshot. Nice pick by Berkey and just shot around. And I don't know. It's early. Hopefully it continues. Oh, we got a long way to go. They got a good crowd behind them.
Thank you very much. Best of luck.
All right. Thanks, C-Mac, and thanks, Dan Stroop. We were saying it earlier. Dan Stroop is such a nice guy. He never brag about anything. But
you were right when you said he's humble. He always says he's lucky.
All firemen are humble. Him and Chris Gill, if I'm not mistaken, at the same fire hall in Vancouver, as a matter of fact. So bragging rights are on the line.
And we're going to get to see Vancouver's power play here. I thought the last time these guys met, Toronto did a great job short man. But the main thing was they pick up loose balls there, short man. We'll see if that changes today.
As we mentioned earlier, Peter Morgan on the crease. Ryan O'Connor running things at the point for the Ravens. This is Chris Gill working the inside there. For Stevenson didn't go. Ryan O'Connor at the point. Chris Gill, sub shot saved by Watson. He comes out to cut off the angle. Bob Watson Allen the ball. With the rock starts things off. Ball goes. Coyle. Shot. Saved by Maetche off Blaine Manning. Ryan O'Connor now for the Ravens, who are on the power play. Moving the ball up slowly. It's a 2-0 lacrosse game in favor of the Rock here at GM Place. 6:50 left in the first quarter. Jamie Bowen on the left side of the power play. In front for Gill. Watson stops him. Loose ball in front of Watson. Whistle goes. We have Vancouver ball. Vancouver looks fairly confident on the power play.
That was a great save. That was a good play. Yeah. They got inside, but Bobby Watson played it great.
Ryan O'Connor backhand to Stevenson, all the way over to Gill. Back to O'Connor's shot. Deflected, goes wide. And here come the Rock. This is Jim Veltman. Has a man wide open. Skips it. He's just going to hang around. No, he's not. Pass in front. What a save by Dwight Maetche. Matter of fact, what a shot by Danny Stroop. Here comes the offense. We have a penalty coming up to the Rock. Darren Rysick, 2-on-1. Shot, goal! There's your first goal at GM Place for the Vancouver Ravens. 2-1.
This was a great shot by Darren Rysick to finish off the play. But here you see, Vancouver's learning. They're starting to do the transition. That was a nice catch by Rysick off of it. But he just picks the corner.
Delayed penalty being called as Dan Stroop ran into Dwight Maetche, and Stroopy was going to get a 2-minute penalty. In fact, he's still going to serve it. So Vancouver will go back on the power play after that goal by Darren Rysick.
I think Vancouver was surprised a couple of weeks ago on the speed of the transition game in this league. You can see they're learning from it.
Yeah, Paul Domenico talked a lot about that the last 2 weeks, about how his team had to get better at that sort of thing. And not to be fooled by, they're not to be surprised, like you say, by the speed of the National Lacrosse League game. So the Ravens go back on the power play again. Ryan O'Connor running things at the point, likes to use that right side with Peter Morgan on the crease, Chris Gill at the shooter position. Stevenson the shot. Switch things around. Now here comes the Rock. Pass ahead for Toll. Shot. Fake. Yes. Man, he got me confused. Million fakes there by Toll. Dwight Maetche stops him.
And that was a great pass by Veltman. This is one of the reasons why their short man is so dangerous. They've got the speed of Toll in the front and the loose ball ability for Jimmy Veltman.
O'Connor at the point to Gill. Back to O'Connor. Down low for Peter Morgan. Pass went right by him. Didn't look like Peter was ready for that. Watson wants the long pass. Here it comes for Toll. They like to use this play. Toll right in, scores.
Oh.
Well, that's a sweet play. And I'll tell you something, that's a team that knows each other well, Brian. They've used that play a lot.
And we've talked about this before. They just throw the ball ahead of Steve Toll. They know he's got so much speed. And this is a difference in this league, too. The way the ball bounces. In the summer league, that ball might be gone.
Yeah, good point.
The first bounce is usually a dead bounce. And you can tell they practice that. That's third breakaway for Toll. The guys kid him. They said if he had the scoring touch of a Dan Stroop, he'd score 100 goals a year.
You know, he faked me out the first time. Didn't fake out Dwight Maetche the other way around.
No, and it's good sign he's mixing it up. He put a fake on the first two opportunities. That time he just shot for the corner.
Got herself a 3-1 lacrosse game here at GM Place. Crowd still filtering in. Yesterday afternoon, they had 13,200 tickets sold.
There you see Stevie Toll at 15 goals last year. Pretty good loose balls. Jimmy Veltman and him getting loose balls, that's great. I think he is going to be an all-star this year. He took a year off to play professional hockey in the East Coast League. Took him a while to get his touch back. But I think he's going to surprise a lot of people this year.
First quarter is brought to you by hotjobs.ca. Log on today and take control of your destiny. Hotjobs.ca. Right now, Steve Toll doing a hot job of giving the Toronto Rock a semi-commanding 3-1 lead in this lacrosse game. Craig McEwen down at the Toronto bench right now.
Thank you, Don.
Les Bartley, the Rock coach, said when they do get back to 5-on-5, he wants to see the Rock work the ball down low a little bit more. Also on defense, he said, hey, if you're not moving, you're standing still, you're not helping us. Keep up the good work, guys.
Vancouver's getting a penalty here. We're going to get to see Rock go to the power play. I think that's Darren Ryzik
going in for...
And that actually was a power play goal he scored on that first goal for Vancouver.
Darren Ryzik, of course, a longtime veteran with Victoria Shamrocks, won himself a couple of Man Cups with the Shammies.
Here we're going to see the penalty. Let's see. I'm not sure what's wrong with that.
These refs are from Ontario. What's going on there? Toronto power play. Pass makes its way through. Dwight Metke had to be sharp there. Had to make a save on an errant pass. Now here come the Ravens. 2-on-1. Murray, shot. Saved by Bobby Watson. Short-handed chance for the Vancouver Ravens. The score remains 3-1. And they got to get the scoreboard fixed here. We can't tell what the score is at this point, but it is 3-1.
Actually, Bruce Murray showing some good speed for a big man. 220 pounds, firefighter. Actually, still 4-on-4. Now the Rock will be going to a power play any second. Dan Stroop just coming on the
floor. Here we go. Colin Doyle running things at the point. Just Stroop, his sub shot hits a leg in front. Rock will have to set up the offense again as the shot clock runs out. It will be Ravens ball. 1:11 remaining in the penalty to their captain, Darren Ryzik. This is Hansen, kid from Burnaby, flips it to Jamie Bowen, kid from Edmonton. Ravens trying to kill off this penalty. Luke Ansley trying to kill off some time. Took a shot to the head there, no call.
And another difference between this league and the Western League, Don, is that the shot clock does count when you're shorthanded. So from a power play point of view, you only have to run around 30 seconds before you get the ball back.
Another save by Bob Watson. Playing a very, very solid lacrosse game for the Toronto Rock, which is absolutely nothing new for this team. Kemp Squire. Murray, they set up the power play. This is Doyle. Toronto power play. Murray, as they switch things around, nice play in front to Squire. Loose ball. And the Ravens are able to come up with a team effort to keep that ball out. Rich Catton for the Ravens. He's got some room, shorthanded. Probably pull up, wants to kill off some time here. 11 seconds remaining in the penalty to Darren Ryzik. We've got a 3-1 lacrosse game at GM Place. First ever lacrosse game, first ever National Lacrosse League game at GM Place. I remember they had a WLA All-Star game here not that long ago. This is Ryan O'Connor on the right side.
We're getting another penalty coming up. This time to the Rock.
Yeah. It's 3-1 for the Toronto Rock over the Vancouver Ravens. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on Sportsnet.
His Mountain Dew in serious jeopardy, this generally harmless male will defend his domain with basic animal instinct. A fierce battle rages. Yet in the end, to the victor go the spoils.
Hey man, how you feeling?
Not bad.
Until next time, do the do.
Dave Thomas has a dilemma. How to decide which sandwich to introduce? The chicken bacon Swiss or the bacon Swiss cheeseburger? Well, he's going to do it scientifically.
Heads is chicken, tails is the cheeseburger.
Both are topped with hickory smoked bacon and processed Swiss.
One's on a quarter pound of fresh beef, the other's on Wendy's whole seasoned chicken breast filet. Introducing both. Wendy's new bacon Swiss cheeseburger and chicken bacon Swiss.
For girls and boys, it's a fact. In every Wendy's kids meal, Grinch toys are back.
Two highly skilled teams square off when Daniel Alfredson and the Ottawa Senators take on Joe Sakic and the Colorado Avalanche. NHL game night, Monday.
Welcome back to Vancouver. 3-1 your score here. And Dwight Metke, your vision from this game, sitting back, what do you like, what don't you like?
Our transition game's better. We're aggressive, more aggressive on defense. We just got to keep going with it.
Great. Best of luck to you.
You know, I guarantee you, and that would not happen as we hear some color from the bench there, that would not happen in the National Hockey League. Can you imagine talking to Patrick Roy after the first period?
In the middle of the period.
Can you imagine talking to Patrick Roy anytime? It's 3-1 here at GM Place. Rock over the Ravens as we got our scoreboard working here. Finally, 2:44 left in the initial quarter here at GM Place. Ravens on the power play. Again, Ryan O'Connor at the point. Morgan with the ball to Gill. Back to O'Connor. To Gill. To Morgan. Stevenson to Gill. Stevenson now at the point as he switches off. Bowen with the shot. Bob Watson makes the save. I've said that a lot already today. Rock looking to kill some time. Nice pass up here to Stevie Toll. He of the two goals as the Rock have a 3-1 lead. One of the goals by Vancouver native Danny Stroop. On the power play for the Toronto Rock. A lot of talent out there, Brian.
Yeah, and the Vancouver power play's really got to be aware of Stevie Toll out there and all the Rock players. They got a great transition going from short man up the floor.
And now,
sometimes, potential problem for Vancouver, they've got a lot of veterans on the power play, some of the better shooters, but slower guys, so they really have to get back. A guy like, you know, Craig Stevenson and Jamie Bowen aren't the fastest guys on the floor, but they need them on the power play. You'll see Toll take off whenever he gets a chance.
And there on the left side here, Stevenson working with Ryan Connor, to Gill, to Peter Morgan, in behind for Bowen. Looking for somebody to pass to. Maybe he'll move up front. No, Ryan Connor with the sub shot. Stopped by Watson. It'll be Toronto ball as the shot clock had expired. 3-1 at GM Place. 1:26 remaining in the first quarter. Rock ahead. A lot of special teams play so far. This is Dan Stroop has one goal in this 3-1 lacrosse game. Dan Stroop down low. Here's Kim Squire. Kim Squire moving in, who tries a shot from an impossible angle, and yes, indeed, it was impossible. Matt Duane ran into some trouble there. Hit the carpet hard. It'll be Toronto ball. Dan Stroop will gather it in.
That was some minor interference called on Scott Whitley there. Probably wasn't wise. He gave the ball back to Toronto. A little excessive pick.
Dan Stroop. Dan Stroop for the Rock, in front, shot saved by Maetche, gathers in the ball, after the save off Blaine Manning. Now they've got a possible fight there to the right of Maetche, it's not going to happen. Something's happening now. All right, well, I think what happened here is that Grant Hamilton came to Dwight's defense there. Brian?
Well, it looked like there was going to be a scrap in the corner for a second. Referees let it go and both players ran away from it. Now, I don't know if something happened on the way to the bench.
Well, I think Kim Squire was yapping a bit at Dwight Maetche, and I think Hamilton came to his defense as a result.
Here we're going to watch this play in the corner here if we're going to see it. Behind the play.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, there's a little shot.
There you go. Dwight had nothing to do with that thing. 3-1 at GM Place. 4-on-4 really opens it up for the offense. As if there isn't already enough action to lacrosse. Shot to goal! Oh, that was pretty. Very, very nice goal.
Chris Gill. Broken play. Some great defense by Pat Coyle on Peter Morgan, but Gill jumps all over that loose ball. Watch his defense. It's a great play.
Talk about your goal scorer's goal. That thing had no business going in.
No, exactly. He just scoops it up.
I mean, he closed his eyes, took a shot, but Chris Gill can find the net any way he can.
He's the ultimate opportunist, Chris Gill.
So we've got a 3-2 lacrosse game at GM Place with 25 seconds left in the first quarter. As the Ravens set up their offense,
Chris Gill gets his 7th goal of the season.
And they pulled Dwight Maetche with 15 seconds left for the extra attacker.
Yeah, this is a good call.
Not a bad. They're going for that last shot. So, in effect, setting up the quasi power play here. Ryan O'Connor at the point. Left side of Peter Morgan. Back to O'Connor. Likes to shoot. Takes it just wide. So the period ends. 3-2. Rock over the Ravens.
You're watching the National Lacrosse League, the Vancouver Ravens' home debut on Sportsnet.
Rogers Sportsnet Ontario. Be there.
Can anybody find me somebody to love?
He works hard.
Every day of my life, I work till I ache my bones. At the end
of the day,
I take home my hard-earned pay.
Oh, on my own.
Somebody. Can anybody find me?
Pizza. It has an FM stereo so you can listen to music while waiting for pizza. It two-ways friends to come over for pizza. It has voice-activated dialing so you can order more pizza.
Pizza.
Without putting down your pizza. The Motorola V-Dot 120. Enjoy it with pizza.
Sony mini disc Walkman, you can record from the net. So wherever you go, your downloads go with you.
Just a reminder that Sports Central is coming up right after our lacrosse game with Peter Labardius. Tonight, by the way, it will be the Broadhead-Campbell combination on the evening edition of Sports Central. 3-2 here at GM Place. Dwight Metke forced to make an early save here in the second quarter. 3-2 for the Rock, by the way. Here comes Darren Rising. He likes these two-on-ones. The pass goes astray to Rich Catton. Ravens stay with it, though. That was Jamie Bowen taking a hit or two. Couldn't get the shot away.
Is he getting another penalty
here? I'm telling you, Brian, what do you think? I mean, there's been a lot of penalties so far, and it's slowing the pace of this lacrosse game down.
I think the referees are calling this like a Man Cup game, East versus West. Toronto's getting it, I suspect. No.
No, it's not like a Man Cup game because the East is actually getting some penalties here.
I was going to say it was too many men on the floor, but I don't think so because they wouldn't send Jimmy Veltman out, the best penalty killer.
So we have a 4-3 situation, favor the Ravens.
Yeah, they called it interference. Something must have happened on the way to the bench.
Peter Morgan down low. That's what the Ravens want to see. His pass goes astray. And here come the Rock, 2-on-1. Going to slow it down. Hopefully knock off some seconds here.
And Donnie, a 4-on-3, I always say I think it should be an automatic goal. These guys, with the sticks they have, they should score on every 4-on-3. The Rock will try to eat a full 30 seconds. But watch when Vancouver gets it with the talent they have. They should be putting one in here.
Boy, sounds like you want to get out there.
I would be nowhere near the power play.
That's not what I heard.
Yeah.
Brian Shanahan, the old Six Nations chief. There's a shot and a goal by Jamie Bowen.
That's like I say, when you get the talent you have out here with the hands these guys
have around
the
net.
And Jamie Bowen is one of the best.
You called it, buddy.
I talked about the speed that he doesn't have, but what he does have is great hands around the net. Watch these moves. 4-on-3, they get Toronto to move. They give a guy open. He's got some great stick work in close.
so great to see a kid from the prairies, from Edmonton, make it at this level. I mean, 10, 20 years ago, lacrosse was totally foreign to people in Alberta, Saskatchewan, Manitoba. Now it's a pretty big deal
out
there.
That's right, and there's like seven or eight guys in the league from Calgary and Alberta, or Calgary and Edmonton.
Caleb Toth for one of them?
Yep.
So it's a 3-3 lacrosse game. Ravens trail 2-0 and 3-1 at different points. We've got 13 and a half minutes left in the second quarter at GM Place. Rock setting up their offense. For once, nobody's in the penalty box. The save by Dwight Maetche, and the Rock maintain control. Blaine Manning with the ball. Blaine Manning in front. Fake shot, goal. Wayne Burke with the old bounce shot and about a million fakes preceding it.
Yes, we talked about Jamie Bowen and his moves in front of the net. Well, here we see the newcomer on the Toronto Rock, Wayne Burke. He gets open. I don't know how they avoided him there, but he puts on about four fakes on Maetche.
Yeah, really took his time there, and obviously a breakdown by the Vancouver defense.
And the good goal scorers know how to make a goalie move, and that's what Burke did. If there's nothing to shoot at, make that goalie move.
Poor Dwight Maetche left all alone by his D. Got another penalty here. Got a hold on the Ravens. I'm telling you, again, I'll say it again. I you know, if I'm buying a ticket today, I want to see the Ravens, not the Zebras.
Yeah, I think they're calling too much right now. They're trying to take the hold out of the game, but you don't want to call the holding call on the center of the floor.
Scott Whitley going off for holding, and the Rock will go on the power play as a result. They set up the PP. Doyle at the point, shot. I think Maetche got a piece of it. Rebound, another save by Dwight Maetche. 2-on-1 for the Ravens. Negated by a sneaky Toronto line change.
And Vancouver has really improved their transition game from the last 2 weeks, and the big reason is Catton and Reisig. They're really running up the floor hard. Reisig's already got a goal for them.
Yeah, he's had the opportunity for a couple of two-on-ones and was successful on one of them, scoring the Ravens' first ever home goal. Ravens doing a good job of killing off some seconds. Now two of them, though, are trapped deep in Toronto territory. This is Doyle for the Rock. Doyle passing, trying some fancy stuff for the Rock. Doesn't work, but they do maintain possession and set up the power play again. Doyle, oh, great no-look feed, and Dwight Maetche has to come up with the enormous save.
That was a great feed and an even better stop by Maetche.
Off Kenny Millen. Here's Stewartson for the Ravens. His shot saved, Bob Watson. Into the corner it goes for Gibson. They get it back to Watson. And here comes Carter Livingstone. You don't expect a guy named Carter Livingstone to be playing. You expect him to be a butler. You expect him to be playing lacrosse.
He's also a quarterback for the University of Toronto Blues.
Dan Stroop loves the sub shot, takes it off Maetche into the crowd. There's a souvenir for one of the 13,000 plus assembled here at the garage in downtown Vancouver. 4-3 to score, the Rock leading the Ravens. Rich Catton with the ball for the home team. Gets it down to Peter Morgan.
He'll be content just to kill this.
They're still shorthanded.
There's only 11 seconds left in the penalty.
Peter Morgan with the ball. Ravens penalty. Whitley now over. Morgan shot, a goal!
Whoa.
Boy, we talked earlier about patience by the Rock, by Wayne Burke. That's some nice patience by Peter Morgan. He had that ball for like 35 seconds.
And what a rocket that shot was. Watch this. He's going to use a bit of a screen up over everybody.
High stick side of Bob Watson, the way he's playing today. It has to be that type of shot to beat him. Hey, but hats off to the Ravens. After that 2-0 start, 3-1 start, they managed to come back and tie this lacrosse game at 4. Dwight Maetche with the ball for the Ravens. Peter Morgan. First goal for the Ravens. Murray doing some excellent job against Lattiser, and I wouldn't be surprised if there's a fight here. Yes, there is. Lattiser against Murray.
Possible Lattiser against the firefighter Murray. I thought they were friends.
It is. It's a competent environment. I thought they were supposed to be getting along these days.
They'll get along after the game, but not right now.
Boy, you gotta hand it to Bruce Murray, showing a lot of guts going up against a gentleman as mean-looking as that. Dan Lattiser, on top of being mean-looking, he's also a big, big boy. But so is Stuart Brimery.
Yes, they're both big boys. And Vancouver is playing a great game. 2 weeks ago, they've improved so much since then. Let's hear what happened. No shots in there. They're both trying to get each other's helmets off.
I think Murray was upset that I was calling him Brian. That's why he was so PO'd there. Bruce Murray, of course. 4-4 here at GM Place. 10:42 remains in the second quarter. Second quarter is brought to you by Wendy's. Two new bacon Swiss combos. Try one today, and hey, why not try one tomorrow? Peter Morgan. Or the Vancouver Ravens. Bowen. Ravens set things up. The shot from O'Connor. Loves that sub shot. Goes astray. Ryan O'Connor losing the battle along the boards. And now the Rock have a 2-on-0. Toll with a shot off the post. Maetche makes the save. Referee saying it's in.
The fans aren't going to like that.
We got to look at this replay.
I thought it was the right call.
Well, of course you did. You're from Ontario.
Toll is having quite the game.
Yes,
right up on the loose ball. Let's see what you tell me what you think when you see it this time.
Dwight making the initial save. Oh, tough to tell from that angle.
Yeah, that is tough to tell.
The referee, Rick Lum, is right there, though, so we'll give him the benefit of the doubt. As number 17, Steve Toll, gets his hat trick goal. As a result, the Rock lead 5-4. Ravens.
Toll's been the most dangerous offensive weapon for Toronto, and everything's come out of his own end.
He has speed. Asley for the Ravens. Asley moving in his shot. Watson getting a chunk of that ball. The big hit. Man, that was a delayed reaction by Pat Coyle. Hanson hit him, and about 10 seconds later, he fell down.
That's right. Hanson just got a little piece of him, enough to knock him off balance.
Matt Duane for the Ravens. Trail 5-4. It's been an entertaining game so far, despite some questionable calls and a lot of calls by the officials. Matt Duane again for the Ravens. Working off the pick. His shot high and wide. Oh, Duane, what was that? What a shot.
Jamie Bowen.
Jamie Bowen, yeah. That was an around-the-world backhander. Kim Squire for the Toronto Rock. 5-4 the Rock lead. 9 minutes remaining. Maetche in place in the first half. Got another penalty here, do we? No, we don't.
No, I don't think so. Just
change
possession.
Call. Yeah. Stewart's in now for the Ravens. He's going to wait for his teammates to help him out. 5-4, Rock over the Ravens. This is Chris Gill. Got one goal tonight. Had a good game in Toronto as well.
And Vancouver goes to a power play here. I guess Dan Lattiser got the extra penalty on the altercation with Bruce Murray.
Shot, score! Jamie Bowen, his second goal today.
Third power play goal for Vancouver. So they're sending a message to Toronto. If you're going to take penalties, we're going to make you pay. Let's see. They move the ball around here. Jamie Bowen's going to take an outside shot.
Nice little sub. Boy, I tell you, having watched that game in Toronto, Vancouver looks so much more confident today.
Oh, yes.
Even better than they did in Ottawa.
Well, I think they were a little overconfident, I think, starting in this league. They're all great players, and I think they thought it was going to be a little easier than it was. But they learned their lesson, and they've regrouped. Yeah. They got a great coach, Paul Del Monte. Plenty of time to look at the game tapes, come up with a game plan.
5-5 now. We're going to take a break right now. As I said, 5-5, Rock and Ravens at GM Place.
Is Mountain Dew in serious jeopardy? This generally harmless male will defend his domain with basic animal instinct. A fierce battle rages. Yet in the end, to the victor go the spoils.
Hey man, how you feeling?
Not bad.
Until next time, do the do.
Mr. Fletcher, Mr. Smith, Ed, it's Wendy's Chicken Bacon Swiss. Tails, it's Wendy's Bacon Swiss Cheeseburger.
Heads.
Call in the air.
Tails.
Heads! Heads!
No, no, heads! Heads!
No, I mean tails!
Can't decide between Wendy's delicious new Chicken Bacon Swiss and Wendy's delicious new Bacon Swiss Cheeseburger? Each topped with hickory smoked bacon and processed Swiss? Try them both. It's win-win.
Hey, Fry Man, over here!
Here you go.
For girls and boys, it's a fact. In every Wendy's kids' meal, Grinch toys are back.
Welcome back, everybody, to Vancouver. Your score all deadlock here. The latest goal scorer, Jamie Bowen. And what does it feel like to score a goal in this building with all these people in here?
Well, it's pretty exciting. I don't think I've ever played in front of this many people. I know I got a lot of friends watching at home, too, so it's a real good, it's a real big treat.
Any stage fright for you guys tonight?
A little bit. I think that was all wiped out 2 weeks ago in our first one in Toronto, and I think we're all okay now, and you can see by the score.
Great. Thank you very much. Best of luck. Up to you, Donnie.
Time to look at the Speedy Drive of the Game, brought to you by Speedy. At Speedy, you're a somebody. I guess we'll get back to that later. 5-5 here at GM Place, Rock and the Ravens. Home opener for the Vancouver franchise. Franchise home opener. Manning now for the Rock on the left side. Gets the ball to Danny Stroop. Back to Manning in front. Pass goes astray. Jimmy Veltman will pick it up for the Rock. Gets it to Manning. Manning working a roll, trying to work a pick and roll. Can't do it. Stewartson has the ball now for the Ravens as we have a delayed penalty coming up on the Rock.
Yeah, this is the goaltender interference they're calling.
Now that was picky.
I don't like that rule.
I mean, you know, I'm a BC boy, but that was picky. Boundary to Gill. Down low, and oh, Ansley takes a stick in the head. Wow.
And a punch in the head.
Play is continuing, though. That was Patty Coyle. And you know, and Pat Coyle knew he did something wrong, trying to pick a fight with Ansley after that, maybe hoping for retaliation. But now Vancouver's going to go two men up.
Okay, we're going to see the penalty here. This is what the goaltender interference. You're not allowed to touch the goalie. Now, that's a terrible call. That's a terrible call.
I don't know about that.
And that's a new rule. And we're going to see the second one. High stick.
Oh, I don't know about that. That's the ACG. I'm just kidding.
But you see, they put a new rule in this league this year that you're not allowed to touch a goaltender. Now, I see the referees are calling it differently depending on where you are, but I mean, that one, I don't even think he touched him.
In front, Bob Watson makes a nice save off Bowen. It's good at that crease. Rock trying to use the Stevie Toll play again. Dwight Metke goes head first into Toll, but it worked. Ravens come up with the ball. Ryan O'Connor from Vancouver, down to Bowen. Bowen yelling out instructions, get the ball back to O'Connor. Stewart's in front. Peter Morgan scores. That was a nice play.
Nice play, 5-on-3. Peter Morgan scores his second goal of the game, end of the season. Last time we saw Jamie Bowen down low finishing it off. Here's an opening. Peter Morgan puts it in. And for the first time in the game, Vancouver takes the lead. They've been making Toronto pay on the power plays. They're 4-for-6 on the power play.
I'm telling you, Peter Morgan is, you know, first game since quitting that SFU basketball program. Thought he looked a little shaky at first in the first quarter, but wow, has he come on strong. Two goals. Here's Toll in front for Squire. Where's that ball?
That was great defense by Rich Pat.
Yeah, it was Darren Rising.
Darren Rising, sorry.
I think he surprised himself. I didn't think he had it. I don't think he knew he had that ball. But bottom line, he was with his man, and when that happens, sometimes you get lucky. Ravens still on the power play, 5-on-4. Manning still in the box for the Rock. Chris Gill. Morgan all the way over to Bowen. Bowen, oh, bounces the shot just wide. Morgan again wants to shop, but the shot clock expires. 6-5 Ravens over the Rock at GM Place. 6-11 remains. Second quarter. Ravens home opener. This is Clark checked. And here comes Chris Gill. He's going to wait for his teammates.
That was a very uncharacteristic giveaway for Glenn Clark. Toronto's pretty sure-handed bringing the ball out of their own end.
Here in BC, Glenn Clark gave away a government. Shot in front, Bob Watson again makes a save. They like to use Bowen down low.
See Glenn Clark stepping into the crease there as he tried to hurdle over it. Oh, call for going back in your crease. Not allowed. You can throw the ball back in, but you can't carry it in yourself.
Peter Morgan, Chris Gill, O'Connor back to Gill. His shot catches a piece of something, goes wide, but Chris Gill gets it back, and the Ravens have a new shot clock. This is Morgan. Bowen, his shot blocked, but look at, wow, what were we saying about Morgan?
Johnny on the spot.
Coming on strong. His third goal.
And that was just as the penalty expired. It wasn't an official power play goal, but it might as well have been. Is this guy showing any rust?
Well, as I said, I thought he started off a little bit shaky, looked a bit nervous, but that is all gone completely. It's now 7-5 for the Ravens over the Rock. Peter Morgan, the new Westminster Salmon Belly star, has himself three goals. Yeah, as a matter of fact, I think he's got three. Yeah, he does. He has three of the last four.
Well, Toronto gets called for over and back on that play. Jim Veltman's arguing with the ref. You're not supposed to call that. I think he's got a good argument on the faceoff. I don't think that's a legit call. And the referees even are going to have to learn this game. We've got Western referees here who haven't reffed in this league.
There you go, knocking the West again.
There comes the Toronto boy.
Shot by Jimmy Bowen, off a leg, goes a straight loose ball. Boy, there's some bodies being pounded there, and Bob Watson is pounding one of them. Vancouver ball, though. These teams beginning not to like each other. Getting that feeling. Kyle Goundry for the Ravens.
And Toronto appears to be getting a little bit frustrated.
It's been a good lacrosse game. In front for Kevin Hansen. He's stopped by Bob Watson on the tough angle, and here come the Rock.
Good lacrosse, but I think too many penalties.
Yeah, Billy. Boy.
And there's one
Matt
there.
Matt Duane took Millen into the boards. And he's lucky a serious injury didn't occur as a result. 7-5 Ravens over the Rock.
Okay?
Yeah, why?
Busted.
PowerShot A10 and A20 digital cameras and card photo printer CP10 from Canon. Are you digital yet?
Climb every mountain, ford every stream, follow every rainbow.
Yamaha's ultimate ATV sale, 7.9% financing and a whole lot more. See dealer for details.
Two highly skilled teams square off when Daniel Alfredson and the Ottawa Senators take on Joe Sakic and the Colorado Avalanche. NHL game night, Monday.
It's Motorola Ask the Pro. Time now to get interactive with one of the stars of the NLL in the Motorola Ask the Pro feature brought to you by Motorola. Intelligence everywhere. This question is for Rock goaltender Bob Watson. Bob, with the nets being wide in the season and the crease enlarged, how does that affect you as a goalie? Take it away, Mr. Watson.
Okay, yeah, thanks, Jim, for the question. Yeah, it's definitely changed the aspect of goaltending. I mean, with the bigger nets, you got to find yourself to challenging the shooter a little bit more, taking another step out to cut down on the angles,
And the inside play is really tough. I guess once they're inside, their stick sees a whole lot more to reach around. So you just got to be willing to commit a little bit earlier and, you know, just hopefully you're reading the stick well and making the right move.
Brian, we all remember the old days when you and I played lacrosse 4x4 nets. Man, the goalies would like to go back to that.
That's right, but their equipment has got a lot bigger too, so it evens out.
Rock power play shot. Oh, what a save by Dwight Metke off Colin Doyle.
Great save. Toronto has to get their power play going. They're 0-for-1 on the power play. Vancouver's been very good on the power play.
Shot scores! Oh, the Ravens are on fire. Kevin Hansen is loving it. He's playing to the crowd. Short-handed goal for Kevin Hansen. Would you looky here? The Ravens leading the Rock by a score of 8-5.
Kevin Hansen playing his first game. They put him in because he's got some speed. Here he shows it coming off the bench. Short-handed goal. This is given. Les Bartley is not happy. That's four straight goals for Vancouver.
Wow. 8-5 for the hometown team. 3:58 remains in the second quarter. Toronto still in the power play. Matt Duane in the box for the Ravens with 1 minute and 15 seconds left in his infraction. Here come the Rock, setting up the power play shot, and a save by Dwight Metke off Mike Murray. Dan Stroop, rink wide, shot, another save by Dwight Metke, this one off Colin Doyle.
He's been solid.
Bob Watson had the hot start. I think Dwight Metke is matching him save for save now.
It looked like he didn't know where the ball was there.
Okay, it's Peter Morgan now. He has the three goals for the Ravens. Still killing off the penalty to Matt Duane. While we're waiting, let's go down to Craig McEwen.
Thank you, Donnie. Les Bartley, the head coach of the Rock, told his players to keep their mouths shut, basically. He thought maybe they were whining a little bit too much. Maybe that might stop the parade to the penalty box and they can start playing some even strength across.
I'll take that, Shanny.
Keep your mouth shut and stop whining.
Boy, the Ravens have done an excellent job of killing off this penalty. Of course, it's not over yet. 15 seconds left. Rock power play. Backhand pass from Jimmy Veltman. Metke with a save and another save. Wow! That, Dwight Metke's putting on a show.
That ball actually went in the net, but he called it on the crease. Metke had fallen into the net. Roddy Squires has a scoring opportunity.
I think he made a crotch save on that one. I'm saying it wasn't in. Power play is over now for the Rock. Here's Morgan moving in, looking for his fourth goal. Shoots it wide, although Watson may have got a piece of it. Back in the crease to Watson. Again, old-time lacrosse fans, you can't do that in the National Lacrosse League. You can't go back in the crease with the ball. In front for the Rock and a goal by Kim Squire.
Oh, this is a great shot by Kim Squire. This is one thing that the Rock likes to do. It wasn't a fast break, but it's still a man coming from the bench. Vancouver, they're picking up a guy. The late change, a guy come from the bench going hard. They hit him and he gets a good shot, Kim Squire. The Rock needed that one. They don't want to go to the dressing room at halftime after having four goals scored on them in a row.
Beautiful pass there by Steve Toll.
This is really turning into a game.
Stevie adding to his point total. Man, he's got some speed. Squire gets the ball back to Glenn Clark. Now Watson has to take control. Clark couldn't handle the pass. Jim Veltman on the left side. Flips it over. Come the Rock again. Loose ball. And oh, boy. Oh, boy. That could have been a lot worse. I tell you, Kim Squire hitting Rich Catton there.
Oh, that's a mismatch inside, but Kim Squire's not afraid to throw his body around. An offensive player, he didn't want to pick up that ball.
Rock on the O, Wayne Burke has got one goal today. Here come the Rock again. Doyle in front.
Another penalty coming.
Squire can't handle the pass, and boy, did Darren Reisig hit Kim Squire. Wow. Now, if I'm not mistaken, there was a penalty being called before that.
Well, that's what I want to see, if they called an extra one on that one. I don't think they did, but I think that second hit was worse than the first one. Here you're going to see this into the boards. That's a dangerous play.
Boy, the ball wasn't anywhere near him.
Now, that's probably what Jim Veltman is arguing with the referee.
Oh, definitely.
He's trying to find out if they're going to give an extra one for that. And no, I don't think so. Darren Rising's just getting two. And that penalty is not for what we saw into the boards. That penalty was a hold that was called a few seconds earlier. And Veltman was trying to talk him into giving 4 minutes.
The second quarter was brought to you by Wendy's two new bacon Swiss combos. Try one today and one tomorrow.
Here we see Paul Del Monte's talking to his team here. He knows it's an important part of the game, but this Peter Morgan guy, I think he's helped him so much. Three goals. He's tough to cover with a size, 6'6".
Well, Paul said that, I mean, and it was obvious after the first couple of games that they needed to improve their offense. You bring in a 6'6" guy with hands like Peter Morgan's, boy, that's going to improve your offense.
Here we're going to see what he did, what he's done so far today. Watch this outside shot he takes. Beautiful.
Pick in the corner there. High stick. There he is at the crease where he likes to park himself.
And this next one is just being the opportunist. Yeah. Picks it up.
Quick hands. Quick hands for a big guy. Quick hands for any guy. Now the Rock go on the power play. Trailing 8-6. Shot by Doyle. Saved by Dwight Metke. Dwight Metke, Channy, is getting stronger as this game goes on.
Well, we've got two good goaltenders here.
And just as I say that, he lets one in. But an excellent play. Doyle benefiting.
Doyle's had some good chances on Metke. Metke's stoned him so far. But this one, he's just going to run up the middle. Toronto scores their first power play of the game. Their power play's been struggling a little bit today. And really, to be honest, they've been a very strong team over the years. The power play has never been one of their strong suits. They've been middle of the pack.
Colin Doyle gets the goal. As a result, it's a one-goal lacrosse game, 8-7 here at GM Place. 1 minute left in the second quarter. And we go to halftime. Rock with the ball. Squire. They make a line change here. Here comes Kim Squire now. Kim Squire's shot blocked. And here come the Ravens. Breaking out. This is Hamilton, Grant Hamilton, O'Connor on the right side to Gowdery. He's got some room. Kyle Gowdery's bounce shot goes wide. This ball's going over and back. Yes, it is.
Now this will be interesting. With less than 30 seconds to go, we'll see if Toronto pulls their goaltender, Bob Watson. This is a play they've been known to do.
Well, as a matter of fact, sorry, Shanny,
they're calling
the
timeout. They might do it.
The Ravens did that at the end of the first quarter.
Oh, exactly.
8-7, Ravens over the Rock. I think everybody in Vancouver, especially everybody in the Vancouver organization, Shanny, have to be very pleased with the way their team is playing today compared to those first two road games.
Well, exactly. It's a tough way to start, and I think Ottawa made the mistake last year too, and a lot of people are saying Vancouver made the same mistake. When they got their schedule, they wanted to play the Rock early because of the fan interest, but that's tough to play a team like the Rock so early in the season and to dig a hole for yourselves. But they're playing great. They look like they're the equal match today.
You know, we saw what Mr. Peter Morgan did for the Vancouver Ravens with his hat trick. Now let's take a look at what Stevie Toll's done today.
Yeah, there you see him score his first goal on a nice pass. Watch this one. Leads him with the pass. They do this to him all the time. He's so fast, it's fast ahead of him. There you see his third goal. That was the one that was questionable.
It did go in. I don't know if that went in. Hey, just a reminder that Monday night on Sportsnet, NHL game night. The Ottawa Senators in Colorado to take on the Avalanche. It starts at 8:30 Eastern time, 6:30 Mountain, 5:30 Pacific. But right now, Sportsnet is at GM Place, where the Ravens are leading the Toronto Rock by a score of 8-7. Time winding down in the second quarter.
And they're waiting for the clock to go down. They want to take their shot with just a few seconds remaining.
Good defense by the Ravens. Excellent defense. and the quarter and a half comes to an end. Boy, I tell you, Toronto Rock thanking their lucky stars there wasn't a few more seconds in that quarter because right. Darren Reisig got a wide open
net
there.
And that's why you see Colin Doyle standing at center doing nothing for about 20 seconds because they don't want to go to the net until they have to.
Let's get out of Craig McEwen at the bench.
Thank you, Don. Paul Del Monte joins me now, and obviously you're happy with the lead, but probably not all that happy with the way it ended up here in the second quarter.
No, I think we had a bit of a letdown right at the end of the quarter, and that's a bit natural. Adrenaline's high right now, but generally pleased with the effort, and we'll go back in there and put a few things on paper and come out a little stronger in the second half.
What would you like to see your team do a little bit better?
Well, we still have to make better decisions with the ball. We just came down at the very end here and shot the ball when we didn't need to shoot it. We could have owned possession of the ball, so we just have to make better decisions with the ball.
Thank you very much, Paul. Best of luck in the second half. We are done here for now, GM Place, but lots more to come. Your score, 8-7 Vancouver. Up next, the Mountain Dew halftime report. Please do stick around.
Rogers Sportsnet. Be there.
Optimism is your weapon, and we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire, and new jobs daily.
With the Sony Mini Disc Walkman, you can record from the net. So wherever you go, your downloads go with you.
Talk about buns o' steel.
Oh, come to mama, big boy.
Tostitos, chips, and salsa. Dig in.
Let loose.
Optimism is your weapon. And we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire and new jobs daily.
Okay?
Yeah, what?
Busted.
PowerShot A10 and A20 digital cameras and card photo printer CP10 from Canon. Are you digital yet?
It orders pizza. It has an FM stereo so you can listen to music while waiting for pizza. It two-ways friends to come over for pizza. It has voice-activated dialing so you can order more pizza.
Pizza.
Without putting down your pizza. The Motorola V-Dot 120. Enjoy it with pizza.
Optimism is your weapon. And we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire and new jobs daily.
Hi, I'm Peter Loubardius in the Sportsnet studios. We'll take you back to Vancouver for more lacrosse in just a moment, but let's check in now on the Toronto Raptors, who had an afternoon date in Atlanta with the Hawks. This is the fourth quarter. Alvin Williams from 18 feet, no good. Look at Vince Carter get up and dunk it home with authority, and people will respect his. Late in the ball game, Carter, he can't respect that pass. Intercepted by Sharif Abdur-Rahim. Goes the distance. I don't know how that didn't go in. He would make the two foul shots, give Atlanta a one-point advantage. So that leaves us with this. 4 seconds to go. Elijah won. Good. And the Raptors win it 104-103. Now, Sports Central will follow lacrosse. We'll feature the Olympic curling trials from Regina, the Vanier Cup, also a couple of games in the NHL this afternoon. Let's now get you back to GM Place in Vancouver. The Ravens trailed 2-0, 3-1 to start this game, but they've come back to lead 8-7 at halftime over the Toronto Rock. The Mountain Dew Halftime Report is brought to you by Mountain Dew. Do the Dew. I want to concentrate on the Vancouver boy playing with the Toronto Rock, Dan Stroop, doing what he does best, putting one into the net. Dan Stroop making it 2-0 at that point for the Toronto Rock, who, as we mentioned, trail 8-7 at the half. Now it's time for our hot shot. Our hotjobs.ca player profile, brought to you by hotjobs.ca. Log on today and take control of your destiny. Let's learn more about Danny Stroop.
Gibson has, oh, what a goal! Dan Stroop, a beauty.
Oh, me and Les talked early in the summer there, just about getting traded to Vancouver. Mainly for family reasons, but it didn't work out, and I'm here for another year, and I'm happy. Best fans in the league, and I'm happy for Chris. He's going to have a good year. He'll help the Ravens out, and they needed a good goal scorer, and he fits the bill. I'm excited. I got family, friends. It's a home game for me, really. I mean, I haven't had a home game in 4 or 5 years I've been playing in the league, so I'm excited. It's 20 minutes to the rink, and I'm ready to go. We got to aim for the top, and we've got a few new players, and they're working out. The team's excited, and we're shooting for a championship, home game again, and hopefully take another cup home and a ring. They haven't said they're expecting more. I mean, I'm hoping to contribute more than I did last year, and but they got a new rule with the crease, so I got to stay out of the crease, and that could be half the battle, but hopefully it works out. Since the 11th September, I mean, there's been a lot more hugs around the house, and a lot more phone calls now that I'm on the road again. So I'd say right now, say hi to my girls at home. They'll be watching the game. Actually, they'll be at the game today. But happy birthday to Danita. She's 6. So families, it puts everything in perspective. You know, it's family's the most important thing.
Joined now by Dan Stroop here in the Toronto Rock dressing room. And first of all, before we talk about the game, talk a bit about the emotions you had leading up to it and coming here and playing in this arena.
Well, I was pretty excited today, actually all week, knowing it was a home game for me, my only one of the season. Got a lot of family and friends in the stands, so I was looking forward to it.
How about the way things have gone? Obviously, Vancouver took it to you for a while, but you guys seemed to right the ship towards the end of the half.
Well, we knew they were going to come out strong. They got a great crowd behind them, and they got a good team. We got to stay out of the box and keep going. If we stay out of the box, play 5-on-5, we're going to do okay.
Thank you. Best of luck to you in the second half. That's Yip from down here right now. Your score at halftime, 8-7 Vancouver. We'll have lots more from the Mountain Dew Halftime Report coming up next.
Optimism is your weapon, and we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire and new jobs daily.
Dave Thomas has a dilemma. How to decide which sandwich to introduce? The chicken bacon Swiss or the bacon Swiss cheeseburger? Well, he's going to do it scientifically.
Heads is chicken, tails is the cheeseburger.
Both are topped with hickory smoked bacon and processed Swiss.
One's on a quarter pound of fresh beef, the other's on Wendy's whole seasoned chicken breast filet. Introducing both. Wendy's new bacon Swiss cheeseburger and chicken bacon Swiss.
For girls and boys, it's a fact. In every Wendy's kids meal, Grinch toys are back.
Optimism is your weapon, and we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire and new jobs daily.
Can anybody find me somebody to love?
He works hard
every day of my life. I work till I ache my bones. At the end
of the day,
I take home my hard-earned pay
on my own.
Somebody, can anybody find me somebody to love?
country.
Just a couple of Team Canada t-shirts.
And a big old can of whoop-ass!
The only thing better than Team Canada is a Team Canada fan. Now inside every specially marked get-together case, you get 12 Canadian, 12 Coors Light, and one of four Team Canada hockey t-shirts, each from a winning era. Must be legal drinking age. No purchase necessary.
Optimism is your weapon, and we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire and new jobs daily.
I do know this. Those aren't the Go-Go's. It's 8-7 for the Ravens over the Rock at GM Place as the National Lacrosse League comes to Vancouver. Let's go back to the first half for our Canon Power Shot of the Half. Brought to you by Canon, leaders in digital photography. Astonish yourself. With a score 3-3, we're going to take a look at what Peter Morgan does for the Vancouver Ravens. Popping one in, high stick side on Bob Watson. Wow, that's our Canon power shot of the half. Peter Morgan, one of his three goals. We'll be back with the second half after this. It's 8-7 for the Ravens over the Toronto Rock.
Optimism is your weapon. And we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire and new jobs daily.
Hi.
Hey.
Everything go okay?
Yeah, what?
Power Shot A10 and A20 digital cameras and card photo printer CP10 from Canon. Are you digital yet?
Optimism is your weapon. And we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire and new jobs daily.
Swiss. Tails, it's Wendy's bacon Swiss cheeseburger.
Heads.
Call in the air.
Tails. Heads. Heads.
No, no, heads. Heads.
No, I mean tails.
Can't decide between Wendy's delicious new chicken bacon Swiss and Wendy's delicious new bacon Swiss cheeseburger? Each topped with hickory smoked bacon and processed Swiss? Try them both. It's win-win.
Hey, fry man, over here.
Here you go.
For girls and boys, it's a fact. In every Wendy's kids meal, Grinch toys are back.
Optimism is your weapon. And we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire and new jobs daily.
The Mountain Dew Halftime Report brought to you by Mountain Dew. Do the Dew. Time now to look at the Molson Export halftime stats in this 8-7 lacrosse game at GM Place. What stands out for you there, Shanny?
What really stands out is the loose balls, 22-15 for Vancouver. Vancouver was really dominated by Toronto 2 weeks ago on that stat, but also look at the power play, 4-for-5 for Vancouver. Actually, I think it was 5-for-7, it was my count. But Peter Morgan got the one that was just after the power play had ended. So maybe not an official power play goal, but it really was in effect because the man hadn't got back on the floor yet. But Vancouver's got to be very happy with what they've done so far. I'm sure Toronto's trying to bring something positive by the fact they scored two goals late in the quarter. But this is going to be a great second half.
Look for a lot of physical play in the second half because, as I mentioned, these teams seem to have a hate on for each other. Our next game on Sportsnet, as far as the Ravens go, Philadelphia at Vancouver. That's next Sunday. It starts at 5 p.m. Pacific, and that's going to be a tough one for the Ravens, Shanny. The Philadelphia Wings, of course, the defending National Lacrosse League champions, beating these Toronto Rock last year in the championship contest.
Yeah, well, I tell you, that's the furthest thing from their mind right now. They just want to win this one badly. And you're right when you say these teams are getting a hate on. It is getting nasty out there. It's looking like a Man Cup game. It's got the East-West flavor in it. The Western referees, I might add.
Keep bringing that up.
and face-offs, too. Vancouver was dominated 2 weeks ago in the face-offs. This time it's a lot closer, 10-8 on face-offs for Toronto.
So according to you, the score is referees 8, Rock 7.
No, I didn't say that. I think Vancouver is playing a great game.
I think the referees have
called too many both ways, to be honest.
O'Connor and Morgan trying to hook up again, as they did a couple of times in the first half. Didn't work there. Chris Gill losing the ball, but the Ravens get it back.
What you see sometimes, Donnie, though, is when the referees are making... Whoa.
Jamie Bowen got a lot of mustard on that one.
When the referees are making a lot of calls, even though it's both ways, the player's frustration level goes up a little more. And that's what I think we've been seeing.
Here comes Millen, Maetche with the save. Both goalies playing well in this game in front. Toll shoots just wide, high and wide, as he looks for his fourth goal of this lacrosse game. Stewartson for the Ravens, moving in 2-on-1. Stewartson shoots, and Watson gets a piece of it. It goes wide. Coyle's just smashed into the boards.
Oh, what a great job by Coyle getting that ball to Bobby
exactly,
Watson.
Exactly, he had two men on him, hammering him, and he managed to get the ball to Watson, and as a result, the Rock is able to set up its offense. Mike Murray for the Rock. From the Rock's offense, Lane Manning shot wide. Stewartson with the ball, overruns it. Still loose. White ball, white orb, still loose. They're whacking away. Shot clock runs out, and as a result, the Ravens get the ball. Shot clock running out on the Rock.
There's some nasty hacking and whacking out there, and Stewartson showing his speed. This is his first game. They added him and Hansen to the lineup for a little bit more speed. We already saw a shorthanded goal by Jeff Hansen.
Or is that Kevin Hansen? Well, there's two brothers, two Hansen brothers.
This here is Kevin. This is Kyle Goundry. The Ravens on the right side. Back to Stevenson. Trying to work off the pick. Not much room out there, being checked by Big Lattisour. A shot in front by Kyle Goundry. Watson equal to the task. Here's Bob Watson. Good with the stick. Gets it to Glenn Clark. 8-7 Ravens lead. 12:50 remain in the third quarter. Kim Squire for the Toronto Rock on the right side. In front. Shot and a save by Maetche off Colin Doyle. Gets knocked off.
Colin Doyle was lucky to avoid the goalie on that. You're going to see Colin Doyle going to the net hard.
Goes in the net hard.
He goes in the net. If he had touched Maetche, they would have been calling him on that. And with the new rule, it doesn't matter if you're hit. You have, it's your responsibility to avoid the goalie.
As Kim Squire set up Colin Doyle again. Maetche with the save. Breakaway. Right in on goal. Matt Duane. Shot. Save Watson. Loose ball. Ravens battling for it. As are the Rock. It's still loose. Ball in behind Watson. He gathers it in. 8-7 Ravens over the Rock. Great save there by Bob Watson. Now some room for Feldman. On the right side for Millen. He makes the save, does Maetche.
And we're seeing a clinic by both goaltenders here, playing great.
Dwight Maetche wants that ball.
How many guys are behind the net?
This isn't rugby you're watching, by the way, folks. It's lacrosse. And the Ravens come up with a loose ball. Stewartson working one-on-one against Toll. Moves in. His shot, Watson. He was down before the shot was taken, but I guess he knew what Stewartson was going to do.
Oh, that was good defense by Toll.
It was, just a, if I'm not mistaken, a bit of a size mismatch there. Let's go down to Craig McEwen.
Thank you, Donnie. Les Bartley, the Rock coach, obviously happy with the way things turned out at the end of that second quarter there. He felt his team weather the storm and wants to continue that momentum. The other thing he said is make sure you watch Chris Gill. Don't let this guy get loose, because obviously he'll be pumped playing here. He can beat you if you don't take care of him.
We haven't heard a ton from Chris Gill. He's being covered very closely by The Rock.
No, but you know, he's still got five assists.
He's still got five assists. I mean,
one goal, five assists. So you think you're doing a job on him.
Goal scoring point of view, I guess I was talking about.
And he's not really noted for his assists either. He's more of a...
Right in on goal, Gill! Stopped by Watson.
There's Gill Johnny on the spot again. That was a fantastic save by Watson. But yeah, he's known more of a finisher. He's not so much a setup guy.
What I was trying to say.
And you're absolutely right. But sometimes you think a guy's not having much of a game, you got to look down the score sheet. 6 points.
Shot goes wide, and here come the Raven. Stewartson. He's got all kinds of room.
I think he was surprised to look up and see that was his teammate beside him.
Exactly. Ryan O'Connor. He of the red shoes. To Jamie Bowen. He of the red shoes as well. Where'd they get those things? From a bowling alley? Bowen now to Ansley. Ansley looking for some room, looking for the sub shot. Moving in. He's going to have to go behind. Heels off. Gets the ball back to Ryan O'Connor. Connor shot goes off Gibson. And the Ravens are able to maintain possession, but they're worried about the shot clock, and sure enough, it expires. Rock ball. Good D by The Rock there, Brian.
Yes, both teams have been playing good D. The next goal, somebody's going to have to earn it.
Pass to Millen goes astray, and as a result, here come the Ravens. Aaron Rysik. This is Goundry. Goundry with some room, looking for it. Back to Morgan. Morgan shot, save by Watson.
That was a dangerous opportunity for Vancouver.
He got a lot on that shot. Morgan in behind now. Big Peter Morgan has three goals to Rysik. His shot scores! Darren Rysik, 8-7, or make that 9-7, Ravens.
Great shot by Rysik, scoring his second goal of the game and of the season. Plays a lot of defense for Vancouver, but here he shows an outside shot right off the post. Watch them set it up with Morgan from behind the net. See this once in a while, they'll set up the offense from behind the net. Morgan's looking for somebody. Rysik wants it, watch his shot. It went off the outside post and just squeezed in.
So now it's 9-7 for the Ravens in their home opener. Bruce Murray, the Ravens. Right side, Ansley. As the Ravens set up the offense, the fans here are having a good time. Ansley shot, bounce shot off the goalpost. And into the crowd. 9-7 for the Vancouver Ravens over the Toronto Rock as Darren Rysik, their captain, gives them a two-goal lead.
And is anyone bringing anything into the country?
Just a couple of Team Canada t-shirts.
And a big old can of whoop-ass!
The only thing better than Team Canada is a Team Canada fan. Now inside every specially marked get-together case, you get 12 Canadian, 12 Coors Light, and one of four Team Canada hockey t-shirts, each from a winning era. Must be legal drinking age. No purchase necessary.
I am Canadian!
You seen the guy in the mailroom?
Oh, talk about buns o' steel. Oh,
come to mama, big boy.
Tostitos, chips, and salsa. Dig in.
Let loose.
Hey. Welcome back to Vancouver. 9-7 Ravens here. And Derek, obviously, this probably wasn't the start that you guys wanted, but you built some momentum. What are you guys going to have to do to take it away now again from the Ravens?
First thing is to stay out of the penalty box, be a little more disciplined, play 5-on-5 lacrosse. We're actually playing pretty well, but we're a 5-on-5 team. We're transitioning the ball well. Mekki's playing extremely well. Hopefully we can put a couple by him, and 9-7 right now. Hopefully we'll get back into it shortly here.
Great, thank you very much.
Oh, a strategy backfires on the Toronto Rock. They pulled the goaltender for the extra attacker, and boy, like I said, did it ever backfire. The man who takes advantage is Kevin Hansen.
Yeah, his second goal of the game shorthanded. We've seen Toronto do this play with success many times. I don't think I've ever seen them get burned on it. They pull the goalie. Toronto pull their goalie. You see everyone hustling back to the bench.
Oh, that did not look like an experienced lacrosse club
And it's a great play, but you have to execute it. But one of the other things about... See, what Toronto does is they try to get the Vancouver defense turned around. They pull the goalie for the extra man, hoping they catch Vancouver unaware. But what happens is the way the benches are situated, Vancouver team caught that because the goalie was coming. They saw that the bench. They were all yelling at their guys. And the worst of all scenarios for Toronto is they gave up the loose ball.
Look at the defense by Rich Catton here on Kemp Squire, making life miserable. Look at Catton all over the floor. Fans are going nuts here, doing the wave, having some fun. Their team's up 10-7. Why not have some fun? Kyle Gondry picks up the loose ball for the Ravens. Back of the crease to Dwight Maetche.
And I saw Kim Squire giving a few shots back to O'Connor after that play. You're right, he is taking a lot of punishment out there. Great defense by Vancouver.
Bowen with the big shot. He's got it, he uses it. That one was unsuccessful. But out of Craig McEwen.
Thanks, Donnie. Toronto a little beat up on the back end. In fact, when Vancouver scored both those goals, two players down the tunnel getting worked on. Daryl Gibson with a sore shoulder. He hasn't returned yet. And Rod Squire got his groin worked on a bit, but he is back on the bench right now.
Yeah, there's a line there. I'm not using it.
Oh, looks like might be getting a penalty here. High stick.
Mike Murray's down. Mike Murray, there's some blood there. Yeah, yep. It obviously hurt. Didn't see what might have cut him. That looks bad.
It looks like he's a little groggy, too. It'll be interesting. Yeah. This might be a five-minute penalty.
You're going to watch the replay, and Murray's going to be on the, I think, the left side of your screen here, come in the middle.
Through the middle. Let's see what happens.
Oh, okay. Boy.
A couple guys sandwiched him. And it's a high stick, but sometimes, though, you know, he was bent over. Leaves himself susceptible. It's a tough game.
Molson Export National Lacrosse is brought to you in part by Speedy Auto Service. At Speedy, you're a somebody. By Doritos, the loudest crunch. And by Motorola, intelligence everywhere. Gonna take another look at the play.
Now watch, two guys are gonna converge on him. See, and that's, you know, that really wasn't a dirty play.
Yeah.
And that was just
kind of went down into the check.
He was trying to squeeze through. Now it's a penalty because you have to be responsible for your stick, but it's not a dirty play. And you know, that could be from his own helmet too after this.
And it's Bruce Murray who goes off for 2 minutes. Shot and a goal. Colin Doyle in front. The nice pass by Kim Squire. We could have another penalty here. As Colin Doyle flattened.
I think they might be calling another penalty, but this is a great composure by Doyle because he knew he was going to get flattened on this play. And this is what I like. The goal scorers can do that. They know they're going to take a hit and they take it.
Squire to Doyle.
Yep, watch. That was I mean, they were right on him.
The big hit was from Catton, who's just been excellent on defense for the Vancouver Ravens. And fortunately there, I guess he got a little too exuberant. As a result, he goes back to the box. And, you know, Ravens had that 10-7 lead. Now they started to take penalties. Just like that, it's 10-8. 7:27 remains in the third quarter here at GM Place. The Ravens home franchise opener.
Captain now 3-for-5 on the power play as they go to the power play again.
Which was a problem for them the first half. Vancouver's own power play outshone the Toronto power play in the first two quarters. Tenney, Doyle with the ball.
And it's Doyle that's been making their power play work, scoring the last two power play goals for them.
I don't know what Kim Squire was doing there, but the pass went astray. If it was a pass, it was a half pass, half shot thing. The Ravens are able to get the ball as a result. Dwight Maetche. Ravens shorthanded, leading 10-8. There's Hamilton on the right side. Dangerous pass for Morgan. Boy, it almost hit Craig McEwen. For once, Craig was paying attention.
And, you know, Vancouver's doing a good job playing the kind of game that Toronto's been known for. It's tough, tough defense, being physical on their opponents.
Feltman to Doyle, the goal. Nice little backhand pass. Feltman to Doyle, bounce shot, two power play goals. What were we saying, Shanny, about Vancouver taking penalties? Boom. Rock is back in this thing.
That's right. Earlier on, we're saying the Toronto power play is not working. Colin Doyle scores three straight power play goals for Toronto. Now the power play is 4-for-6, and they look like they're hot. And Vancouver's got to worry. They got to stay out of the penalty box.
Well, I tell you, that's three straight for Doyle, if I'm not mistaken.
You're right.
The Ravens haven't played well ever since I criticized Ryan O'Connor's and Jimmy Bowen's red shoes. Right after that, they went right downhill. 10-9. Suddenly, the Rock down three just moments ago within one. Doyle again. Dan Stroop with the Stroopian sub shot. He likes those. Dwight Mehke makes the save. Here comes the Ravens offense. We haven't seen much of it over the last few minutes. It's been all Rock as a result of some Ravens penalties.
And Toronto was putting on a good press there, but Hansen did a great job of getting his ball out within the 10 seconds. You only have 10 seconds to get over half in this league.
Chris Gill on the right side for the Ravens, trying to move in against Squire. Chris Gill has the ball stripped. Mike Millen. Rock starting up court. 10-9, they trail. 5:20 remaining, third quarter. Lane Manning. Oh, the crowd is sure quieting down a lot here, Shanny.
Looks like a game of momentum, and Toronto has it right now. Oh, but look at that work in the corner by Murray.
Boy, Murray had Squire all lined up.
Well, yeah, that'll slow you down if you're running in the corner and see a big guy like him coming
no
at you.
No kidding.
Hard.
He's been involved. Come the Rock again. Wayne Burke's got one goal shot by Rod Squire. Goes wide. Shot by, oh, it's all tied up.
Steve.
Wow.
Steve Toll, and this is Steve, Jimmy Feltman is getting in the offense, gets his second assist in a row. They use him more in a defensive role now, but the key is he scoops on the loose ball. Jim Feltman in the corner, not much of a battle for the loose ball. And Toll showing something he hasn't shown us today, his outside shot.
Yeah, most of his goals have been the result of his speed and
exactly
shot
transition
in close.
Game.
This we see what he can do on the outside. It's 10-10 here at GM Place, the Vancouver Ravens and the Toronto Rock.
It orders pizza. It has an FM stereo so you can listen to music while waiting for pizza. It two-ways friends to come over for pizza. It has voice-activated dialing so you can order more pizza.
Pizza.
Without putting down your pizza. The Motorola V-Dot 120. Enjoy it with pizza.
His Mountain Dew in serious jeopardy, this generally harmless male will defend his domain with basic animal instinct. A fierce battle rages. Yet in the end, to the victor go the spoils.
Hey man, how you feeling?
Not bad.
Until next time, do the do.
Get hard line.
Get hard line.
Go ahead. Welcome back to Vancouver, everybody. The score 10-10 here. Obviously, a game of momentum swings, and right now it seems to be swinging Toronto's way. What do you have to do, Darren Rysik, to get it back?
Well, we're on a bit of a downside right now. We took a couple penalties there, and Colin Doyle made us pay with two goals, and then Steve Toll got one from outside, so we're going to have to get back to working hard. We did in the first half and the start of this quarter here, and see if we take the lead on them again.
Obviously, you guys got a good start to this second half. What would it mean to you to win a game here in the first time in front of all these people?
Well, that's everybody's goal, so that's what we're going to be shooting for. And if we just get back to working hard like we did in the first half, hopefully we can get that win.
Thank you very much.
Just a reminder, the NedBank Golf Challenge can be seen tonight on Sportsnet at 7:30 p.m. in the East and Ontario regions. Tomorrow at 8 p.m. in all regions. Mike Weir burning it up there in South Africa. As a matter of fact, he's just three shots in back of Ernie Els. Jim Veltman more involved in the Toronto offense in the second half. His pass to Jan Stroop goes astray. Matt Twain's able to take advantage. Here comes the Twainer trying to outrace a couple of rocks. Back to Goundry, back to Twain. Matt Twain trying to pass down low. Couldn't connect.
And that was a part of their game that was non-existent 2 weeks ago. Vancouver's really running the ball up the floor hard. Now that call was just a minor interference, but Toronto didn't have the ball on the stick. He got hit from behind. It's not a penalty, but it's just a turnover. The fans didn't like that.
10-10, 4 minutes left. The third quarter, this is Kim Squire. Kim Squire making moves, trying to roll in, trying to reach around. Dwight Maetche couldn't do it. Maetche has been playing very, very well ever since maybe the early stages of the first quarter.
That's right. Vancouver nearly put it in their own net there. That's the downside about being able to pass it back to your own goalie. You got to be careful.
Murray to Rysik. They can't connect.
Rysik was on the wrong side of the floor there. It was difficult to catch.
Wide open. Give a shot. And Maetche with the save. Off Darryl Gibby. The Gibster. Darryl Gibson.
Now, that's a great save by Maetche, and this is one they need right now.
He's played very, very well. Must be the yoga. Vancouver's playing much, much better than they did in Ontario a couple of weeks ago, although you wouldn't know it by the last few minutes, Shannon. They got to pick their socks up here.
Well, I guess what Toronto has been successful in doing is quieting down the crowd a bit by scoring three quick goals. Here you see Toronto is going for the fast break again. Clark passes it up. This time it's Gibson, not Toll. Nice save by Maetche. And we did a couple of games last week with young goaltenders in Calgary. And here you see experienced goalies make quite a difference for their team. And just like hockey, if you've got a great goalie, it doesn't matter what kind of defense you're playing in front of them. If you have young guys and experience, it makes a big difference. These guys, Maetche and Bob Watson, what they do for their team.
Well, you want experience. We're talking experience with Dwight Maetche. The man is 40 years old, in incredible shape. And we were joking about the yoga, but the guy, it's one of the reasons why he's in the shape he's in and able to play at this age.
Oh, exactly.
Just a reminder that Sports Central is coming up right after the lacrosse. Your host tonight, Lou Peter Labardius. And later tonight, it'll be the Campbell Broadhead tandem. There they are. Good old RJ and Jamie tonight, 10 o'clock on Sports Central Primetime. Meantime, we're here at GM Place. Ravens and the Rock tied at 10. And obviously, Dwight Maetche has an equipment problem.
We've seen a lot more of him. Next week, Philadelphia is playing here. 37 saves today.
I got to ask you, Shanny, what's the deal? I mean, people ask me this all the time. What's the deal with the equipment that the goaltenders wear? I know the goal is bigger, but is there any rules and regulations as far as width goes?
Yeah, it's supposed to be. You can't come more than 3 inches away from your body, and I don't even know how they measure it. And it's supposed to conform to the shape of your body. It's been a gradual thing in lacrosse. The goaltending equipment has just got bigger and bigger, and it's not for protection. It's really for
stopping the ball.
It's exactly. It's not to protect them. It's to take up more room. Mm. And they're finally starting to get a handle on it. But they got these rules. But that's why, the big net, I don't think, is huge. If you look at the goalies 15 years ago, they look so small compared to these guys.
Similar to hockey. Feldman's pass goes astray. Rock maintained possession. Dwight Maetche with a nice interception there. Here comes Kyle Goundry now. Pass from Maetche. Left side to Sturridson. Sturridson working on Millen. Sturridson waiting for his team to catch up. Ravens decide to make a change. That's Morgan to Gill. All the way back here. Stevenson. Stevenson to Morgan. Big Peter Morgan can't miss him out there. Morgan loses the ball for second, gets it back. Peter Morgan, the shot clock expires.
And that's when you know there's good defense being played, when you hear that shot clock go off often.
Boy, the Rock has really picked it up here in the last few minutes.
I'll tell you, next goal is a big goal. Vancouver scores it, this crowd's going to go crazy.
Shot and another save by Dwight Maetche. Ravens break out. Rich Cat to Darren Reisig. He's shot. Watson makes the splits, makes the save.
Great shot, and Reisig has been great today, showing why he's the captain, the leader of this team.
Kim Squire, right side for the Rock. 10-10 to score. Come the Rock again. Toll shot. Maetche gets a piece of it just enough. It squeezes by the right post. I thought that thing was going in. O'Connor can't pick up the ball. Still loose. The Rock, what a hit there by Kyle Goundry. But Doyle still has the ball. Good job by Colin Doyle up front to Feldman. He's behind the net. Tried to wrap around a shot past Maetche. It didn't work.
He didn't have much of an angle.
Like a contortionist on that shot,
right.
Jimmy Feldman.
He tried to will it in.
Hansen loses the ball. Here comes Toll with Feldman. Toll. His shot saved Maetche. Boy, he's playing well. The Ravens get possession. We're back in the crease to Dwight Maetche. Keeping his team in this thing right now. Hansen, easy pass, and he lets it get by him. All the way down, Watson to Clark. They can't hook up.
There's two unforced turnovers, one by each team.
Yeah, a little sloppy pass there. We've got 1 minute left in the third quarter. Peter Morgan with the ball for the Ravens. They're all tied up 10-10 with the Rock. Peter Morgan working one-on-one. His shot high, wide, but the Ravens maintain possession. They have to watch the shot clock, though. It's winding down. Hansen's shot saved by Watson. His pass to Livingstone. They can't connect, but Glenn Clark is there to mop up. Rock on the line change. This is Burke. Burke to Squire. Kim Squire bouncing around. Kim Squire gets hit hard. It went right back at Matt Duane, and Duane prevails. Puck in the ball in the crease now. Yeah, I called it puck again. Kim Squire is getting into it.
Grant Hamilton.
Size mismatch, and it shows. But Kim Squire's coming right back at him.
And he better watch with a helmet on. He's going to break his hand.
That's a battle. Boy, the fans are loving it here at GM Place.
The best thing about the Coors Light Silver Sweet football party is you don't have to play football to get in. See details at a participating bar near you. No purchase necessary. Must be legal drinking age. Are you ready for some football?
All right, back at GM Place. We're going to take a look at how this whole fight started. Hamilton and Squire.
This is just intense work on the loose balls. Kim Squire gives Hamilton a shot. And Hamilton's smart. You know, get into it. If as dangerous as Kim Squire is offensively, anytime you can go off with him, it's a great way. It's good defense. You're covering a guy. What's the best way to cover him is put him in the penalty box and sit next to him.
Kim Squire should know you don't mess with a police officer.
That's right.
Especially one from Victoria.
But Kim Squire's too valuable to his team to be going in the penalty box.
That's the end of the third quarter. The Ravens and the Rocks still knotted at 10. Ravens at one point led 10-7 in this third quarter. Dwight Maetche right now holding the Vancouver Ravens in this thing.
Optimism is your weapon, and we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire and new jobs daily.
Sony Mini Disc Walkman, you can record from the net. So wherever you go, your downloads go with you.
Optimism is your weapon, and we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire and new jobs daily.
It orders pizza. It has an FM stereo so you can listen to music while waiting for pizza. It two-ways friends to come over for pizza. It has voice-activated dialing so you can order more pizza.
Pizza.
Without putting down your pizza. The Motorola V Dot 120. Enjoy it with pizza.
Can anybody find me somebody to love?
He works hard.
Every day of my life, I work till I ache my bones. At the end
of the day,
I take home my hard-earned pay
on my own.
Optimism is your weapon, and we're in your corner. With thousands of companies looking to hire and new jobs daily.
The third quarter was brought to you by Dodge. Grab life by the horns. Big chance in front. And Dwight Maetche, man, I think he hit his head on the post there.
Yeah, he looks like he's either hurt or he's stuck. I think he's stuck.
Or a little of both. Boy, what a save by Dwight Maetche. That's why it remains 10-10. Comes the Ravens offense. Chris Gill's shot, saved by Watson.
Kim Squire and Grant Hamilton are in the penalty box. Joined with them is Pat Coyle, one of the Rock's best defenders. Got 10-minute misconduct, probably for something he said to the referee.
And we, for some reason here at GM Place, we've lost our penalty clock, so bear with us as we try to figure out what's going on penalty-wise here. Shot in front for Stroop, just sneaks by the right post. Stewartson's wide open, can't grab the pass from Dwight Maetche. Loose ball in the corner to the left, Bob Watson. They battle away for it there. Picked up by Wayne Burke. 10-10, 13 and a half minutes left in GM Place. The Ravens, home franchise opener. Both goaltenders putting on a show tonight. Dan Stroop. For the Rock, back to Blaine Manning. Having some trouble. Gets the ball back, takes a hit, maintains control. Or does he? Yes, he does. Blaine Manning on the left side. Trying to work a pick with Stroop, and Dan Stroop is flashed by Kyle Goundry. What a hit. Dan's from Vancouver, but right now, I don't think he knows where he is.
And Kyle Goundry, an offensive player. He had a big weekend a couple weekends ago. He hasn't done much offensively, but look at this defense.
What a hit.
A bit of a suicide
pass.
Oh,
my God.
Blaine Manning gives Dance Troop.
Here's Ansley. Here's Ansley for the Ravens. Works the ball to Stevenson. Stevenson back to Ansley. Ansley with two men on him. Takes a step back. Loose ball now. Chris Gill should pick it up. Yes, he does. Chris Gill's shot is the... Had to take that as time expired. Boy, that thing went flying. The shot clock expired. The thing went flying into the crowd.
Somehow, Dan Ladouceur ends up with Chris Gill's stick in his hand. He threw it into the corner.
Vancouver crowd. I'm telling you, they have to stay awake with shots like that going into the season. Shot by Manning is wide. Gets his own rebound. Metke makes the save. Now,
great goaltending both ends. And I think you're right, of late, Metke's been holding them in.
Yeah, because the Ravens, as evidenced there, are getting sloppy. Getting a bit sloppy, maybe a bit nervous coming down to crunch time. Toronto Rock, much more used to playing in these tight situations. Another save by Dwight Metke, that one off Colin Doyle. Here come the Ravens. Stewart's can't get the pass. They're upset. Now Burke for the Rock on the left side. Looking for the trailer. McMillan. To Doyle. Shot to goal. The Rock take their first lead in a while. It's now 11-10 for Toronto.
And the fans are a little upset. Vancouver had a good scoring chance. Cotton moved the ball up the floor, and I think this is going to hurt.
That thing came all the way from the other end.
Yes.
Boy, you can't blame Dwight Metke. He's made so many great saves, but I'm sure he'd like to have that one back.
No, you're absolutely right. You're going to see a good finisher by Colin Doyle, who has been hot of late. Nice shot. But really, lacrosse is one of these games that you better make the most of your opportunities, because the ball comes back up the floor very fast. And that's why it's, you know, when you got a goalie who's hot, makes a save down one end, it comes back. But that time, Kevin Stewartson had a hard time handling the ball. The pass by Catton on what looked to be a nice play. Ball went right back up.
Rock again on the offense, on the attack. This is Blaine Manning down low to Doyle. Metke has to make a save, although I believe Doyle was in the crease.
Metke giving him a friendly tap as he tries to get out.
Darren Rising moving in. Shot saved by Watts. Got the old pins closed there. Now the Rock have a breakaway. Ladouceur shot saved by Dwight Metke. Dan Ladouceur, not known as a great goal scorer, but boy, you got to put those ones in.
No, well, that's not the man. He'll get one breakaway a year at the most. But good for him. He saw an opportunity and he went. He's going to be a little tired on defense after that sprint.
Shot and a goal.
Jamie Boyne, I just said, Ladouceur might be tired. It's not often you get the big defensive guys have to sprint up the floor and back. And he got beat by Jamie Boyne on that cut flat-footed. Watch. You see Boyne up high. Ladouceur has just finished a sprint. Is up here.
Nice move.
Oh, nice move. Bowen just gives a little stutter step. Here's Ladouceur's breakaway. We talk about it.
One big save at one end, goal at the other.
We just saw the reverse of that a minute ago. Jamie Bowen gets his sixth goal of the season, third of the game.
Kevin Hansen, left side for the Ravens. This is a great lacrosse game. 11-11, 10 and a half minutes left at GM Place in the Ravens' home opener. Peter Morgan for the Ravens. His shot off the goalpost. New shot clock for the Vancouver squad. This is Hansen. Kevin Hansen for Vancouver. Moving in. Got some room. All of a sudden, the defense closes in on him. Still with the ball. Tries the pass.
That was
Bowen.
Good defense.
It was.
Carter Livingston. Kenny Millen.
Jim Veltman wants to just cool things down a bit for the Rocks. Set up the offense. 11-11, 10 minutes left. Wayne Burke on the left side. Gets it back to Stroop. His shot. Metke out to cover the angle. Rebound. They score. Colin Doyle. Got to cover
Colin
your man.
Doyle has been hot. And you see Vancouver made a mistake here.
Well, Dwight Metke makes the save here. Rebound goes out.
But watch. I'm thinking
looking
Grant
around.
Hamilton, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Looking around for that ball. And Doyle was right on top of it. See, he turned around to look at it.
Darren Rising just looked the wrong way. It's unfortunate.
He looked the wrong way, and Colin Doyle was right on top of it.
Clock back in front, 12-11 now. Here comes O'Connor, taking a hit from Clark, but stays with it. O'Connor, they work it around in front to Matt Duane. Watson makes the save.
That was some nice passing there, unfortunately.
Very nice.
Matt Duane was on the wrong side of the floor. Tough angle.
Matt Duane again for the Ravens. On the right side, they work it around. Chris Gill gets the shot away, but goes way wide as he got bumped just as he took it. Now we have a penalty.
Somebody's holding.
It's Chris Gill. Did he make contact with Bob Watson?
Well, I saw Gill's stick was in the corner. I don't know if he's
Looks like he's getting a holding call. Colin Doyle has five of the last six Toronto goals. Rock over the Ravens, 12-11.
Ultimate ATV sale, 7.9% financing and a whole lot more. See dealer for details.
You seen the guy in the mailroom?
Oh, talk about buns o' steel. Oh.
Come to mama, big boy.
Tostitos, chips, and salsa. Dig in.
Let loose.
You know, we weren't sure what the call was. We thought it was on the Ravens. Turns out it was Bob Watson who got the holding call. Hey, the fourth quarter is brought to you by Yamaha Motors. When you want the best, and by Canon, leaders in digital photography. Astonish yourself. As I was saying, Bob Watson gets the penalty there.
Yeah, I think he
That's
grabbed.
What we understand. Yep.
He grabbed his stick and threw it in the corner and got caught. Here, this is what we think it's for. Let's watch. Okay.
Raven in the crease. There you go.
Yes. Oh, no, wait a second.
He just grabbed his stick.
I don't know what happened there.
Call. That couldn't have been the call.
We saw Gill's stick in the corner. 4-for-7, the Vancouver power play, first power play of this half.
Setting it up, here's Gill on the right side. To O'Connor, back to Gill. He'd love to shoot to Bowen. Is deadly with that shot of his. That one, though, goes wide.
The first half, referees were calling a lot of penalties. This is the first power play for Vancouver this half. So I guess even the referees have settled down.
And the game's been better as a result. 12-11, Rock over the Ravens in the fourth quarter. Colin Doyle has been murder on the Ravens. He's out there right now.
Five goals he's got, and five of the last six Toronto goals.
Here he is again, Colin Doyle being checked by Matt Duane. Gets the shot away, got by Dwight Metke, but it went wide. Darren Rising on the right side for the Ravens. They make changes. Passes the ball off to Chris Gill. Chris Gill down to Peter Morgan. Ravens setting up the power play. Ryan O'Connor at the point on the power play. They work it around. In behind for Peter Morgan. Looks like he wants to come on front. To Bowen shot! That looked like it went in. Yes, it did. That was a bizarre play because the ball actually crossed the goal line and then had some action on it and spun back.
I didn't think it went in. I'm going to have to see this again. Obviously, they're calling it a goal. Jamie Bowen, I think he's got his fourth of the game.
I think it went in, had some mustard on it, some English on it, and spun back. You can't tell from that angle there.
No, you can't tell from that. Let's see from here. I think you might be right. Here, let's see. Watch where the first bounce goes. Can't tell.
Yeah, a little tough to tell there.
Now you're thinking that it didn't go in?
No, I still think it went in. From the angle we have up top here, it looked like just what I said, that it crossed the goal line and had some top spin on it, whatever, and came back out.
It's the Ravens home opener from GM Place. We'll be back after these messages.
Okay?
Yeah, what?
Busted.
PowerShot A10 and A20 digital cameras and card photo printer CP10 from Canon. Are you digital yet?
His Mountain Dew in serious jeopardy, this generally harmless male will defend his domain with basic animal instinct. A fierce battle rages. Yet, in the end, to the victor go the spoils.
Hey, man, how you feeling?
Not bad.
Until next time, do the do.
Reminder, on December 3rd, on Monday, it's the Hockey News Show with Darren Millard, Nick Kiprios, and the boys, 4:30 Pacific, 6:30 Eastern Time. Also, NHL Game Night on Monday, Ottawa, Colorado, starting at 5:30 Pacific. This is the shot you wanted, Brian. Now, you better come up with a good line for these.
Well, I'll tell you, Caleb Toth has a pair of shoes like these, and Teddy Dowling was calling Dorothy all game, and he didn't know why.
Yeah, hey, you know, if you click them three times, you go back to Kansas.
Well, if you click them three times, you score four goals. He's got a hot hand. Jamie Bowen, power play specialist. Their power play has been hot.
And Jamie's not the only one. Ryan O'Connor's got those shoes, too.
Yeah, he's not the only one we should make fun of, right?
I'm sure his teammates are taking care of that, and The Rock as well. But they're working tonight. Something's working. Here comes the Ravens offense. This is the red shoot. Ryan O'Connor, his shot off a rock and into the crowd. So it will still be, if I'm not mistaken, Ravens ball. O'Connor again. In front to Gill. Shot.
Whoa.
Boy, he got flattened.
He did.
Shot
you don't see
line.
Him
Watson
missing
might have got
often.
A piece of it. Squire in behind. Bob Watson starting things off for The Rock. This is Glenn Clark. Glenn Clark to Dan Stroop. 12-12 the score at GM Place. Said it before, we'll say it again. This is a heck of a lacrosse game at the garage, the Ravens home opener. Doyle, little shovel pass in front to Beltman. Tries the backhand, gets crunched. Ball goes wide. Here's Dwight Metcalf.
Look
Metcalf.
At the corner there. A little wrestle in the corner. Kim Squire. He had to work with the referee before he goes to the bench.
Peter Morgan now. Off the pick. Morgan's got some room. Back in front to Ansley. They can't connect. And away comes The Rock. Toll with room. In front. Can't connect with Clark. 12-12. 6.5 minutes left. This is Colin Doyle. Colin Doyle to Burke, his shot wide. Stewartson grabbing the ball for the Ravens. Good job on the loose ball there by Kevin. Over to Kyle Goundry. Kyle working one-on-one with Millen. Eases up a bit. Into the corner, the ball goes. Here come the Ravens. Ansley can't handle the pass. As a result, The Rock pick it up. Livingstone on the left side. They make changes, both teams. Toll, who was so effective in that first half. To Colin Doyle, who's been so effective in the second half. Colin Doyle looking for some nice little feet. And Dwight Maetche forced to make the save off Kim Squire, who gets flattened by Kyle Goundry. Maetche now on the right side. Here comes the Ravens offense. Matt Duane taking his time, looking for someone to pass to. Matt Duane. On the right to Todd, or to Chris Gill. Raymond's working the ball around nicely. Not getting as low as they would like at this point. Here's Morgan, his shot. Boy, he gets that thing away nicely. Doesn't look like he has room and all of a sudden,
he gets a lot of power behind those shots. That didn't miss by much. Vancouver's been doing a great job on Kim Squire. He's taking a beating out here. One goal so far today. He wants the ball now.
Stripped to Kim Squire. Lane Manning can't corral the pass. And here come the Ravens. This is Bruce Murray. He'll hold up, wait for the rest of the Ravens to catch up to him.
And that was wise of him there. A couple weeks ago, Vancouver might have taken that shot, but now they see they're outnumbered. They hold up, get the rest of the guys on.
Ryan O'Connor at the point. Got that nice shot into Luke Ansley. No room there. Ball bouncing around. Ansley picks it up, gets it back. The rocks all over him. Look at that backhand shot by Ansley. Great job of staying with it.
I can't believe
he
made it through. And a penalty is coming on Toronto now. They pull their goalie. Vancouver pulls their goalie.
6-on-5 now. O'Connor at the point. Chris Gill. O'Connor in front to Ansley. Shot off the post. And we've got a Toronto penalty, as you said, Shanny.
Somebody got caught holding.
You want to go one-on-one against me.
Powerade and Hockey Central Saturday's Drop the Gloves feature are giving you a chance to go one-on-one against Cujo. If you have an opinion about hockey, just send in your video to Hockey Central Saturday and you could be spouting off on national TV. Plus, you become eligible for a chance to win the Powerade grand prize that'll fly you and a friend to Toronto for a one-on-one against
me,
Curtis Joseph.
Drop the Gloves, brought to you by Powerade.
And watch Hockey Central Saturday for all the details. When did you get so tough?
It's crunch time, brought to you by Doritos, the loudest crunch. Or maybe this is the second loudest crunch.
The Murrays. That's the hit on Bruce Murray on, watch it, Mike Murray. That's no way to be treating your little brother, is it?
No, I don't think so.
No relation, I hope.
Boy, that was a hit. Again, I don't think it was necessarily a dirty play.
No, it wasn't at all.
Yeah.
He was bent down, and sometimes your cage or your mask is what actually cuts you.
That's why lacrosse players wear cages and masks. Back in the old days, again, they didn't wear those things, and Lord knows what their faces look like. Just a reminder that the Sportsnet web address, very simple, sportsnet.ca. We've got our Ask the Pro program. You want to ask a National Lacrosse League player a question? That's your opportunity, sportsnet.ca. Now, Ravens on the power play. Effective in that first half. Gill to Morgan. Back to Chris Gill. Ball, working it to Bowen. Bowen's got the nice shot. To Ryan O'Connor, who's also got a nice shot. Bob Watson with the save.
With 3.5 minutes to go in the game, this is a huge power play.
Here come the Ravens again in front for Morgan, and his shot is blocked.
Oh, and that was a risky play. Steve Toll was up
way
the floor
there.
He thought Toronto had the ball, and he took a chance and stayed up the floor. Vancouver actually had a 5-on-3 there for a couple of seconds.
1.5 minutes left in the penalty to the Rock. Dan Stroop. They're shorthanded. They got the ball.
I think, Donnie, if Vancouver had realized that Toll was caught up the floor,
yeah,
they would have taken their time and moved that ball around a
you
little
bet.
Bit more.
You bet. Doyle with the shot. Easy save for Dwight Metke. And here comes the Vancouver power play.
3 minutes to go is still a long time, but at this point, any goal could potentially be the winning goal.
As they set things up. Ansley out there on the power play now. Todd Gill at the point, different formation here. Here's Morgan to O'Connor, or to Bowen, his shot. Couldn't really get it away there. Up on the air she goes, loose ball. Veltman racing after.
Whoa.
Took a hit, up ahead now. In front for Bowen, and he takes a big shot, but the Toronto player who hit him is the one who's staying down. That's Pat Coyle. Let's go down to Craig McEwen.
Thank you very much, Donnie. NBA has Jack Nicholson. It looks like lacrosse has a big scar in Tom Arnold. Tom, your thoughts of your first ever lacrosse game?
I love this game. It's pretty interesting and a little violent, which makes it very nice. It's a lot like hockey. It's a lot like Canada.
What are you doing up here? What brought you to the Vancouver?
I'm filming a movie up here, and I'm also doing my television show that I have with Fox down there. And so, you know, any opportunity I can to see something fun like this. Pretty incredible, these guys. They got real jobs and everything, and I mean, it's an exciting game.
Great. Thank you very much, Tom.
Thank you.
Back upstairs.
Appreciate it, buddy.
I'll tell you, Tom Arnold nailed it. It is an exciting game. Just ask Dwight Maetche. His heart rate just went up 100% there. Steve Toll coming down on him again.
He's seen more than enough of Steve Toll for one day.
Here come the Ravens. Mr. Morgan. Boy, they're happy to have him in the lineup. Morgan hanging on to that ball. Back to Hanson. Evan Hanson moves in. Scores! Somehow that thing stuck in there. Might have gone through his legs, just squeezed through.
You're absolutely right. Toronto just kills the penalty. And it looks like they're playing good defense. Near the end of the 32nd clock, and Hanson takes that shot from the bad angle. Let's see if we can figure out how it goes in here. And good defense. He doesn't have much.
All through the legs.
Just squeezed through. Something you don't see happen to Bob Watson too often.
Shoot the ball, anything can happen.
Now this is going to be crunch time, a minute and a half to go.
13-12, Ravens up, minute and a half left, as Shanny just said. Don Taylor here at GM Place, along with my color man, Brian Shanahan. Here comes the Ravens offense again.
Now watch for the Ravens to try to use the 32nd clock before they take a shot.
Take every possible second.
A minute and a half to go. You can win the game with three possessions.
Jamie Bowen hanging on to the ball. The pass to O'Connor. His shot. Watson makes the save. The ball was sitting beside him for a few seconds. It looked like it might trickle in. It didn't.
Are we going to see a timeout from Toronto yet?
Here we go. Timeout Toronto. You call the Chatty.
Oh, the fans are loving this.
I'm no kidding. I mean, they could not ask for anything more. By the way, the attendance tonight, I believe it breaks an NLL franchise home opener record, 13,772.
That is fantastic, and you're right, it breaks a record of 12,000.
Hey, it's time to look at the Speedy Drive of the Game, brought to you by Speedy. At Speedy, you're a somebody. This is from the first half, Shanny.
Oh, yeah, I think this is the long bomb pass. This is a beauty. You know, it's like a quarterback throwing it to a receiver.
Boom.
He's fun to watch. And how big is that save that Maetche just made on Toll?
No kidding.
Half a minute ago.
Appropriate that that Toll goal was sponsored by Speedy. Let's go back down to Greg McEwen.
Thank you very much for joining the man of the match right now. What was it like netting that goal in front of all these people?
It's great. You know, it's the hometown fans. You wanted to come out here and prove to them lacrosse is a real sport. Show them a good time, and hopefully they'll come out with the win. Still got a minute to go, though.
Great. Thank you very much, Kevin. Best of luck. Up to you, Donnie.
Oh, boy. The fans could not ask for a better game.
No.
The Ravens leading the powerful Rock 13-12.
Del Monte's looking like a genius, putting Hanson in the lineup. He's got a hat trick.
Bob Watson wants to lead the crease. Can in front for Squire, and the save is made by Maetche again. Nice setup there from Doyle. Here come the Ravens. Bob Watson wants out, can't do it right now. Matt Duane with the ball, 37 seconds left. Ravens up by one. This is a great lacrosse game, folks. Now we've got a whistle.
Vancouver's called the timeout this time.
Not a bad idea.
Now they've got 20 seconds left in their shot clock. They're going to want to kill the ball for the full shot.
Quarter was brought to you by Yamaha Motors, when you want the best, and by Canon, leaders in digital photography. Astonish yourself. Fourth quarter, of course, still going on, and what a fourth quarter it is. 13-12 for the Ravens over the Rock, you bet. Paul Del Monte is yelling instructions to his young Ravens lacrosse club. They're on the verge of pulling off what I would think would be considered an upset.
Oh, it would be huge. It would be great for this franchise, but they've got only 15 seconds, 16 seconds left in the shot clock. They will just spread out and try to kill that 16. And then Toronto has 15 seconds left to pull their goalie and try to put this in overtime.
I don't think that was the Ravens mascot. I think that was Ravens co-owner Tom Mayenek doing cartwheels. I mean, he couldn't ask for a better game. 13-12 with 30 seconds left.
If they
Ravens
can pull it off with a win, he'll be doing cartwheels for sure. But watch for them to cut Toronto to press and for these guys just to try to kill it.
Chris Gill. Keeping that ball close to his body. Doesn't want to give it up. Won't take a shot either. Wants to get the clock down as
to as low as you can.
And let's see what kind of press that Vancouver puts on. Okay. Now that Toronto has the ball.
Okay, 14 seconds left. The Rock and will Toronto, have the ball.
Their last timeout. You get two timeouts per half. And Bobby Watson will be straight to the bench here. No hiding. Yep. This is why you practice 6-on-5 all season for these opportunities. And you know, it comes down. There's a lot of games you see where it's a big play.
What do you think of that strategy just now?
What?
Well, should you have taken a shot there?
No.
No?
No.
You don't think so?
If you have a chance, you take and try to get a rebound. But I'm where he was, there's no point just throwing the ball away, giving a potential. But I agree, if you have a chance, take the shot and get the rebound.
Here, you come around, okay? Mike, you're going to play off, okay?
Oh, I got ball.
We're going right away. We lose the ball, boys. We lose the ball. We fucking got to press, okay?
Bowley's got the ball. Droopy, you come.
You Mike, you got it.
Man. You look
manny.
Play.
Hey.
I think, I think basically their strategy is get the darn ball and shoot the thing.
I think, like we heard in the beginning of the game, one of the keys to the game is to score more goals here.
Yeah.
They just put it in. And you heard him say, if they lose the ball, you got to press. Well, I think if they lose it, there's no time left.
8 seconds in front. Maetche makes a big save. Wow, off Blaine Manning. That's going to be the lacrosse game. The Ravens salt it. I don't know if that one will count by Bruce Murray, but the bottom line is that the Vancouver Ravens have won their home opener, and this huge crowd of 13,772 are loving it. The final score of the Ravens, 13, the Rock, 12. Huge goal with a minute and a half left by Kevin Hansen of the Vancouver Ravens. Some kind of game, Shanny.
Yeah, that was a great game. Both teams played well. And as I said earlier, Kevin Hansen put in the lineup. First game of the season. And Dwight Metke, too.
As a matter of fact, Dwight Metke, our Bolson Export Player of the Game, and deservedly so. We thought that at first Bob Watson was having such an outstanding game. You know, maybe I'm playing Dwight Metke for the first few minutes, but boy, Dwight took over after that.
They both played really well. Yeah. It was kind of a weak one that Bobby let in at the end of the game there. A lot of stars.
National Lacrosse League on Sportsnet is brought to you by Bolson Export. Add X today. Hey, listen, I'll tell you something. 13-12, the Ravens over the Rock. Boy, nobody has left this building. They're still going nuts. They're happy. Boy. Let's get out of Craig McEwen.
Thank you, Donnie. Dwight Metke, the player of the game, as we picked you. What's it like to win here in this building?
It's great. You know, we couldn't have asked for a better way to have a game. Turn out one goal victory with 2 minutes to go. It's just great. Just what we needed.
There were so many momentum swings, and yet you guys came out of this off. How anxious was it for you guys at the end?
Well, we knew Toronto's a great team, you know, and they showed how great they were last game we played them. So this game, you know, they can score at the end, as we've seen in championship games already. So, yeah, it's a little nervous at the end when they're coming down 14 seconds left.
Congratulations. Thanks a lot. Let's go upstairs now, Donnie.
Great job, C-Mac, and obviously a great job by Dwight Metke. 13-12 for the Ravens over the Rock. Coming up next, Sports Central with Peter Labardius. Just a reminder that our next game on Molson Export National Lacrosse Action, Philadelphia at Vancouver. That's next Sunday at 5 o'clock Pacific time. From GM Place, I'm Don Taylor, and for Brian Shanahan, good day, everybody.